Amen. Glory to God. Can we say hallelujah? Hallelujah. Can we say thank you, Jesus? Can we say hallelujah? Hallelujah. Can we say hallelujah? Hallelujah? Can we say hallelujah? Hallelujah? Glory to God. We're going to sing just that song. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. 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 Lord, I love you. 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 Lord, I praise 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 you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Can we raise our voice together and say, thank you, Lord. Lord, I thank you. 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 Say hallelujah. 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 Can we say hallelujah? Can we say hallelujah? Can we say thank you, Jesus? Can we say thank you, Jesus? He said, oh, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All ye lands, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he who have made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pastures. Enter into his gates in thanksgiving, into his courts in praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Amen. Glory to God. As the Lord has spoken to me about the seven generations, glory to God, to make sure that I'm cognizant of those who are in the earth. Amen. From the greatest generation from 1901 to 1924. Glory to God. And the Lord said, think about Abraham. Glory to God. Abraham, glory to God, was promised by God that a child would come from his loins. And even though he tried many things, we know in the 1900s, that's the innovative years. Glory to God, where they're trying to set a foundation and inheritance to be built up. Glory to God. And so Abraham bought a piece of land. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The Bible said Abraham believed God and it was credited unto him for righteousness' sake. And the Bible said righteousness exalts a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. Glory to God. The Bible said blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And so for Abraham, his generation, glory to God, has been set up. Glory to God, hallelujah. Some of those of you who have people in your family, glory to God, that are still, amen, alive from the 1901 to 1924, the Lord wants you to connect, amen, with that person, glory to God, to recognize, glory to God, that just like Abraham, glory to God, there was a setting up, amen, to see the will of God being done in the earth. And the Bible says in Genesis 22 that Abraham was told to bring Isaac, to take Isaac, his only son, and to bring him up to Mount Moriah. Glory to God. And that's what this kingdom takeover apostolic gathering has been about. From the upper room, glory to God, and all of this entire edifice. Amen. 310 20th Street, Southeast Cleveland, Tennessee, 37311, and 2007 King Edwards Avenue, Southeast of Cleveland, Tennessee, 37311. On my right, on my left, before, behind, and all the way around from Jerusalem, all Judea, Samaria, to the ends of the earth. As it is in Acts 15, it seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us, rebuilding the tabernacle of David. Glory to God. And as you always know it, it's not my lighthouse. The Lord said it's God's lighthouse, Tabernacle International Ministries. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Serving the nations, the place of love and care for the nations as an apostolic camp. Glory to God. And so we want to focus in, glory to God, that one generation to another will praise the Lord. So yes, the greatest generation, 1901 to 1924. Think about Abraham. Glory to God, who believed God, and now we are living on credit because Abraham believed God. As he told, amen, God told Abraham in Genesis 12, he says, go to a land where I will show you. Glory to God Almighty. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And then we get into the silent generation, those who are born between 1925 to 1945. Glory to God. As a matter of fact, my grandfather, Isaac Williams, the late Isaac Williams, amen, he was born in 1925. And so when you think about the silent generation, think about Isaac, the son to Abraham. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I led my grandfather to Christ at 91 years old in the nation of my birth of Jamaica, glory to God, by giving him the story of Genesis 26, glory to God, hallelujah, glory to God, and how Isaac had to redig the wells that his father Abraham had. And this is so important as you're rebuilding the tabernacle of David, understanding where we are in history, glory to God. And so the Bible tells us that when Abraham led, glory to God, hallelujah, glory to God, hallelujah, when Abraham led the Isaac up to Mount Moriah, the Bible said, glory to God, that Isaac said to, glory to God, amen, glory to God, that Isaac said, glory to God, to his father, glory to God, he said, Father, I see, glory to God, the wood, and I see the fire. Where is the sacrifice? And the Lord will provide. Can we say that the Lord will provide? Yes. He said the Lord himself will provide a ram. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So it's important for us to come into a place where we recognize it's not by our might or by our power, but it's by the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. Can I get an amen? Glory to God. It's not by your might. It's not by your power, but it's by the Spirit of the Lord. Glory to God. When the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Glory to God. There is freedom. Glory to God. And we have to just be obedient to the Lord. As Isaiah 1:19, for the faithful and the obedient will eat the fruit of the land. Glory to God. So we give God all the praise today. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank God for his grace and his mercy. Glory to God and his keeping care. Glory to God. God has been faithful. Glory to God. So when I led my grandfather Isaac Williams to the Lord, glory to God, and representing the silent generation, and glory to God, 1925 to 1945, the Lord said, lock in everything that I have given to you. And my grandfather blessed me. Glory to God. As a matter of fact, I took a picture, amen, of my husband and I, glory to God, and my family, my three children, glory to God, and I put it under his pillow. I said, amen, Grandpa Isaac, when you sleep, I want you to roll over on it as much as you can. Amen, glory to God. Shift the camera for me, please. Amen, glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Just turn from here along, please. Glory to God. Thank you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So we thank God for his grace and his mercy. Glory to God and his keeping care. Always want to honor the Lord for my husband. Amen. And glory to God. And the Lord has chosen us to be a, if you want to put it, the first family, the last shall be first. Amen. Glory to God. And thank God that the Lord has brought us here into Cleveland, Tennessee. Glory to God. Hallelujah. To be a conduit and a pipeline. Amen. For the next generation. Amen. To honor the Lord for, amen, the two of us have come one. Amen. Glory to God in the apostolic, prophetic, evangelistic, pastoral, and teaching grace. I speak of none other than Mr. Frank G. Hinson. Glory to God. Just place him on the screen for me, please. Glory to God. But I always honor the Lord for my husband. Glory to God. As I'm wearing, glory to God, this very robe when we started and consecrated God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries. I was a little much smaller, amen, than I am now. Amen. Glory to God. I'm still small, right? Amen. So as you can see. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I want to thank God for my husband. Amen. Glory to God. His parents were born in the silent generation. Amen. His mom is 88 years old. Honor the Lord for Mother Hinson. And his father is in his 80s. And the Bible says that Moses said, amen, if God tarries, Psalm 90, he'll give, amen, a year, and 70. If God permits, you get another 10, amen, 80, amen, glory to God. So we thank God for his grace and for his mercy, amen, glory to God. Amen, can you shift this around so mom can see the screen, amen, hallelujah, glory to God. So we thank God for his grace. Honor the Lord for my three beautiful children, glory to God, amen, elder and pillars, Alana, Kadeen Hinson, Frank Hinson, and Micah Caden Hinson. I want to thank God for his grace and for his mercy. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. To God be all the glory for the great things he has done. Amen. Is it good? Amen. Thank God for them.
Amen. Hallelujah. To God be all the glory. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to honor the Lord also for my father, Bishop Michael Williams, who came at the beginning of this Kingdom Takeover Apostolic Gathering on March 10th. Glory to God. Thank God for him. Glory to God. We give God all praise, all glory, and all honor. Glory to God. My father and I baptized my grandfather, three generations. Amen. Glory to God. We're together. So we thank God for his grace and for his mercy and for his love. Amen. Glory to God. So we give God all praise. Amen. Hallelujah. To know that one generation to another will praise the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So we thank God for his blessing. Amen. Upon our lives. Glory to God. Amen. So know what generation you represent at all times. Glory to God. Amen. So you're able to lock in properly. Glory to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. So, amen, when you look at the Isaac generation, the silent generation, that's when you're trying to put things back in place and back in order. Glory to God, to make sure things are in alignment. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I know that we have, some amazing servants of the Lord. We have Pastor Sandra Daner. Glory to God. Amen. And go ahead and place on the screen so mom can see how beautiful, amen, her daughter looks. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. And in a moment, you're going to get to hear Pastor Sandra, amen, Daner, just to share briefly, but mom, amen, mom Elaine Daner, she's going to be sharing and just honoring what God has been perpetuating, amen, in her life, amen, glory to God, to see what her and her husband, amen, her late, amen, servant of the Lord, husband, amen, Pastor Daner, Pastor David Daner, amen, we're rebuilding the tabernacle, David, so she's in the house today. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So, amen. We're going to be listening to what she has to say from the upper room. Amen. Glory to God. The Bible said the mother of Jesus was in the upper room and all the nations were gathered. Amen. Mommy Lane, she told me, amen. Mom Lane, can you come wave? Amen. Can you come wave? Just a wave unto me. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Glory to God. I just want you to see that Mom Elaine, and she is in the silent generation, aren't you? Because you're 81. So you're in the silent generation.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. So we bless God. So this is Pastor Sandra Dana. Come beside your mom, let everybody know that you're not a bastard child. Praise God. Let's come over some more. Make sure we are seen properly. So this is Pastor Sandra Dana. Amen. Glory to God. You just saw it on the screen. So in a moment, we're going to give this duo, amen, these great duo, amen, women of God. They're going to come and share their testimony, amen, later on, amen, before we finish up in the upper room. To God be all the glory. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you. Amen. In Jesus' name. You'll be back in a moment. Amen. Hallelujah. So we thank God for the different generations of leaders and what God is saying, what God is doing in the season. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And so now we get to which generation? We get to the baby boomer generation. Amen. Glory to God. And the baby boomer generation are those born between 1946 and 1965. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And these are amazing leaders. Glory to God. And the Lord said, think about Jacob, who wrestled and become a nation, and think about, glory to God, think about Jacob, and think about Moses. Moses had to lead the children of Israel, amen, to cross the Red Sea to be able to go into the promised land. And so it's very, very important for us to recognize where we are. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. So make sure you know what generation you're following. Amen. Jacob wrestled with God and he became Israel. He said, I won't let you go until you bless me. Glory to God. So it's important for us to come into a moment where we're receiving the blessing of the Lord and the favor of the Lord. And from the baby boomer generation, my father's a part of the baby boomer generation. Glory to God. Then we get into the generation X. Amen. My wonderful pastor and apostle, you're here. Amen. And I think just like my husband and I, we have a bridging of generations. Amen. Glory to God. My husband is in the generation X. I'm in the millennial generation. Our children are generation Z. Amen. Glory to God. So you have to know. So the generation X, if you notice, they're up and down. You have to kind of pin them in the middle. It takes a while. This is a generation that usually the parents that went out to work, so they had to become big brother, big sister, almost like mother and father raising others. Amen. The generation X. So you have to be patient with the generation X. It can be a little bit much at times, but they're bridge gappers. Amen. Glory to God. Would you agree, Pastor Dejian? Amen. I want to honor the Lord. Amen. For the servants of the Lord who are in the house, I want to highlight them. Amen. Apostle, amen, Junior Staple and Pastor Dejian Staple. Amen. Just come alongside, wave to the people. Glory to God. Hallelujah. They're going to be coming later on to tag team to just let it rip from the upper room. Glory to God. And I'm going to just come and put the crown on the top afterwards. I want to thank God for them. Amen.
Blessed. Good morning, everyone across the nation. We are here again in the upper room giving God thanks for all that he's doing. Welcome to each and every one of you as you tune in to hear what God has to give today. Thank you all.
Amen. Praise God.
We bless the Lord because of his goodness towards us, because his mercies endure forever. Let me greet you all in regular land and all across the world. And television and YouTube, you name Facebook, wherever you are, greetings in the powerful name of Jesus Christ. God bless you, and you keep on keeping on in the power of his might.
Amen. Praise God. Thank you so much. Amen. To God be all the glory. So when you look at the Generation X and the Amen, Lord of God, when you think about Generation X, the Lord said, think about Aaron. And Aaron was the brother to Moses, amen. And he had to bridge the family to come back together. God told, when Moses said he can't go for God to Pharaoh, he's stammering and all that stuff, the Lord said, I'll send you Aaron. Aaron became the priest. And even though Aaron died because he offered up strange fire, but he had to be the one to dress properly, amen, to go in and to take the sacrifice, amen. So it's important to really be a part of understanding the Generation X. They are bridge gappers, amen. Bridge gappers, they're constantly bridging the gap, and then we have to honor them that they stabilize, amen, the middle. Glory to God, amen. Are you bridging the gap, Pastor?
Yes.
Bridging the gap, amen. Glory to God, amen. How much years are you older than me? 1 year. She, by the ear of her chitty chin chin. Amen. Glory to God. What year were you born? Tell me. I know it was June. 79, that part. I just wanted to make sure she knew when she was born. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. So we thank God for the bridge gappers. I really thank God because I told Pastor Deji that she is a true pastor and a prophetic anointing is upon her life. And then having Apostle, her husband, amen, is a great connection. Amen. Glory to God. As my father, Bishop Williams, consecrated their marriage together. Amen. It's a great way to see that together we get to move together. Amen. It's so wonderful. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So when we are walking in these levels of knowing, we have to know who we are. So when you think about the Generation X, think about Aaron and think about Joshua. After Moses died, Joshua had to be strong and courageous, amen, to take over, amen. So training, amen, the next generation to take over. In the kingdom takeover apostolic gathering, aren't we? Yes, we are. That's what it says. Rebuilding the tabernacle of David, amen. So you come to my generation, the millennial generation, those who are born between 1980, which is the year I was born, 1980 all the way to 1994. And we are connectors. We connect the dots, people to God, forming a network of God's kingdom builders. So you have the bridge gappers and the connectors. We're connectors. And the Lord told me that for the millennial generation, we are like Joseph, who was the son to Jacob, who helped Egypt and all the world, inhabited world, to be able to have enough food. And when Joseph told them, say that you're shepherds, I want to speak to all of you, amen, just like the elders and the apostles along with the church, according to Acts 15, gathered everybody. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So we're able to know that Jews and Gentiles ought to serve the Lord. The time is coming now, as Jesus said, when true worshipers worship the Father in spirit and truth. So when we think about it, Joseph told his brothers when they finally came back and confessed, he said, what you meant for evil, God has turned around for good, for the saving of many lives. So for me here, being in Cleveland, Tennessee, I heard my dad said this past week, amen, he said, if the father, that the brothers of Joseph almost convinced their father that Joseph was dead, they were willing to pat their pockets and then to put, amen, blood upon the clothing of Joseph, the robe of many colors, amen. Glory to God. If you see, I keep wearing my robes, glory to God, and make sure it's properly aligned. Glory to God. It's important to be properly dressed to serve. Amen. I'm here to serve. Amen. If you want to call yourself black, white, Asian, European, Cherokee, glory to God. Amen. Asian. Glory to God. Whatever group of people that you represent, glory to God. Amen. I call it the several P's. If you're among the Pope, the President, the Pauper, the Prime Minister, the Pimp, the Prostitute, or the People. Amen. Whichever one you fit. Amen. Glory to God. I'm here as Mother Apostle to the nations to serve the nations for Jesus Christ. Amen. Jesus said, for this reason came I into the world. I told the Lord this morning, I said, Lord, you're the reason why I came into the world. I have nothing else to do whatever you want me to do. Amen. I'm fully committed to the Lord, completely locked into the Lord Jesus Christ. And so for that, I am eternally grateful. Amen. I'm eternally grateful. God has been faithful to me. Glory to God. And so when you think about the millennial generation, think about Joseph. Then think about Esther. Esther, amen, she said, if I perish, I perish. I must see the king. She was willing to ask her maidens to fast with her for 3 days. I said, if I perish, I perish. I must. Can you say I must?
I must.
Yeah, you're going to make it in. Anybody can run your race. Glory to God. You have to run it yourself. You have to get the baton from the next person. Glory to God. Don't unwrap the baton and start arguing with people. No, let God do his work in you. Amen. Isaac was of age, but he could have told his father, I don't want to be on this altar. His father was about to kill him because God told him. But Isaac laid on that altar willingly. Why? Because he said, you know what? I cannot displease my father who saw struggle to have him. Amen. Just like Jesus, he was willing to obey his father. Come on, somebody. Amen. You have to obey. I always said it, that my spiritual father and my biological father is my father, Bishop Michael Williams. The Lord told me that. And the Lord said, it's better for him to be your spiritual father first before it's your biological father. Amen. Because we're all creating the image and likeness of God. And when we understand the image of God, amen, we understand fatherhood, the fatherhood of God, amen. It's very, very important. And we think about the woman and the womb carries mankind, female. Female means fetus, the F-E is the fetus, amen. So you carry the fetus. So all of us were created in the image and likeness of God. That's what the Lord said. Let us make mankind in our own image and in our own likeness. Genesis 1, 26 to 28, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the bird of the air. I'm just giving you some doctrine as we're going through generation to generation, because that's what Acts 15 is about. It seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us. And it's important to walk through that. So when you look at Joseph, then you look at Esther, then also Ruth. Ruth was willing to move from being a Moabitess. Even where the Moabites came from? The Moabites came from Lot, who was the nephew to Abraham. And the Moabites, because to preserve the generation, the Bible said that, amen, they made their father drunk because Lot's wife actually looked back and became a pillar of salt. We don't want nobody to look back and become ineffective. The Bible said we are the salt of the earth. We are the light of the world. We have to make sure that we are salty. Amen. Glory to God. So people want to drink more of Christ. The Bible said, oh, he that thirsted, come to the water and drink. Come without money, come without price. Isaiah 55. Glory to God. It's important. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Amen. And the word of God is Jesus Christ himself. He is God the Son. He's God's man and man's God. He is the second Adam, the last Adam. He is the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning and the end. And the Bible said in 1 Corinthians 15 that after Christ has gathered the nations, he will turn the kingdom over to the Father, who has actually placed him, Jesus, amen, over all of us. And Christ is building his church. We are the church. And he said the gates of hell will not prevail against it. So those of us who have done our ABC, accept, believe, and confess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, amen, we become the church. And we have to be taught, amen, to be led and to walk by the Holy Spirit. Amen. So this is very, very important when we think about it. So Ruth told Naomi, amen, entreat me not to leave you or return from falling out to you. Where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I lodge. Your people be my people. Your God, my God. And when you look at Ruth chapter 4 in the Bible says that when Ruth had the child with the kinsman redeemer, Boaz, the Bible said that they attributed that son to Naomi. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Whose name was Obed. And Obed had Jesse, who's the father of David. So you have to know how to realign yourself. Can you say realignment? Yeah. Like when you repent, it means that you're going one way and you turn the other way. It's 180 degrees turn, not 360. If you want to go back to where you started, you want to go and you want to turn the other way. You have to repent. You have to rebuild. That means there was a structure already in place. But you have to go and find the blueprint. Instruction before construction. You can't construct something you have no blueprint for. And Christ is the blueprint. Amen. The Bible said in Romans 8, 28 and 29, glory to God. I know that's apostles, one of apostle staples scripture, Romans 8. Amen. In Romans chapter 8, the scripture says, amen, that God causes all things to work together for the good to those who love him and are called according to his purpose. But look at verses 29. We seem to miss it a lot of times, amen, when we are quoting Romans 8. Amen. Romans 8, verse 29. Here's the image. Here's the image. Everybody ready for the image? My husband told me some years ago, he said, sweetie, image is everything. Yeah. I was taking a selfie. Y'all know I look really cute. So I was taking my picture. You look cute too. Don't be upset with me because I'm just bold enough to tell you I'm cute. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Amen. So the word said, glory to God, that verse 29, here it is. For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to become, to be conformed to the image of his son. Didn't you just say that? We now become conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. Never forget it. From this day forward, and the Lord wants that to be your theme scripture, amen, in July, Apostle, amen, Romans 8, 28 and 29. Glory to God, because we want to see perfect imagery of the Lord. Yeah, full the anointing of God. Can you just lift your hands to the Lord right now? Just thank him, amen, because he's putting some things in order. We're rebuilding the tabernacle of David. Amen. Are you ready to rebuild? I feel the anointing of God. I feel the great unction of the Almighty God. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Lord, I love you. Can you just tell the Lord you love him right now? Tell him. Lord, we just receive all that you're blessing us with, God. You deserve all glory and all praise and all honor. It's due unto your name, Almighty God. Thank you, Lord God, for preparing us to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving to be a living sanctuary for you, Lord God. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Say, I love you, Lord. Come on, tell the Lord you love him. He's doing a work right now. He's doing, amen, hallelujah, surgery on our hearts. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews 4 and 12, the word of God is quick and powerful. It's sharper than a two-edged sword. It cuts the divine soul and marrow and knows the intent of the heart. I told Apostle Junior Staple today that today is the day that he's completely healed of any diabetes. Glory to God. Anything that's wrong in his body, because God has brought him in. The 28 years of friendship that I've had with Pastor Dejan Staple have brought, amen, Apostle in to where he needed to be. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Pastor Sandra talked about when she was a baby, she went through all these issues and difficulties, but God was allowing the mantle, glory to God, of her father, Pastor David Daner, glory to God, to be laid upon her properly. And now, mother, amen, glory to God, mom, Elaine Daner is here to testify what God has accomplished. Somebody bless God in this house. We have the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's a God of the living and a God of the dead. And the Bible said, being so compassed with so great a cloud of witnesses that have gone before us, we'll yes, not even sin and wait that so easily beset us. And run the race in patience, looking on faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despite the shame. And now he's still in the right of the Father. He said, consider who endures such affliction of sinners, lest you become faint in your mind. Amen. Glory to God. To God be all the glory. So we have Joseph, we have Esther, we have Ruth, and we have two more. We have Daniel, that represents the millennial generation. Daniel was willing to be carried into captivity, and he asked for 10 days that they don't eat the king's meat. He knew that the king Nebuchadnezzar, had took the vessels from the temple in Jerusalem and carried to these other gods. Those of you can't be worshiping God and not realize those who come to steal from the house of God. The Bible says when you find the devil, he had to pay up. Come on, somebody. The Lord has been talking to me about some people here in Cleveland, Tennessee. Not everybody can go with me, but there's some people. Glory to God, when I came to Cleveland, Tennessee, the Lord told me, North Cleveland Church of God, I knew where I was staying. Glory to God, which is where Pastor Sandra Daner and Amen, Mommy Lane Daner, glory to God, actually attended. Glory to God, and under the leadership of Pastor Mark Williams, amen, and Pastor Sandra K. Williams, amen, glory to God now, amen. I told him, I said, we're going to be away this Sunday, and two Sundays, amen, because the Lord tells me that North Cleveland Church of God is now ready. It's predominantly white, predominantly Caucasian, amen, glory to God. I was looking at leadership the other day, glory to God, and one of the things that I see, I'm just going to say what the Lord is telling me to say, like I told the now overseer of the Church of God, amen, Dr. Tim Hill, I told him, I said, God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries represent the Philadelphia church, but the Church of God represents the Ephesus church. That's the first church that God wrote to, amen, in Revelation. Jesus sent a word to the church of Ephesus because they had lost their first love, and they had to return to their first love. But the Bible said that the Ephesus church knew the true apostles. Yeah. Amen. So it's important for us to get into motion. Glory to God. So I'm here to help the Church of God. Is that okay? Glory to God. Last year, Kingdom Takeover Apostolic Gathering, we had on the 12th of March, we had Dr. McGuire, who came to speak here. Amen. Glory to God. Down in the broadcast room. Amen. Our studio room. Glory to God. He spoke. And he walked me around telling all the leaders, I told him that he's my Naomi. He's telling the leaders, you need to listen to this woman of God. Amen. So I'm here to help the Church of God. I knew where I was when I came from Tennessee, well, from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Glory to God. And I came, hallelujah, to Tennessee. The Lord said, this man was tending at the hotel. I was staying at the Mountain View Inn. And this man was there, and I said, what church do you go to? He said, North Cleveland Church of God. I said, where is that? Because I knew about Cleveland, Tennessee from Jamaica. My late pastor, the late Pastor Talbert Williams, he mentioned Cleveland, Tennessee, and the Lord said, one day I'll send you there. I didn't know the Church of God was New Testament Church of God in Jamaica until I came here to Tennessee. The Lord said, I'm letting you know the history so you can help the people of God. Amen? Hallelujah. Never underestimate who God sends to help you. Amen. Glory to God. So when I came here to Cleveland, Tennessee, I tell people, don't waste my time. I don't care if you're black, blue, pink, or white. Amen. If you're one eye, kaka, or no eye. Amen. Glory to God. Just flow with the Lord, because it's always from God's mouth to my ear. Amen. And we can't remain in ignorance forever. Amen. That's what happened in Acts 15. They were ignorant. The Jews, amen, wanted to just have the Holy Spirit for themselves. And they didn't understand what they ought to do. Yes. Amen. And we have to make sure we help. Amen. So I was looking at the board. Amen. I look at the council of 18 within the church of God. I don't think you have any representative from other nations in the board. How are you going to have, amen, a group that you're leading, 185 nations plus, and you have no representative in your council? That's not of God. Amen. Just telling you the saying, amen. The other day, glory to God, I noticed that they were doing the new council at North Cleveland Church of God. Amen. The Lord is just going to come out. So pray for me. Amen. I'm not, don't shoot the messenger. But I recognize that on the board, it was more older people that were on there, and nobody, amen, of brown melatonin skin was there, or any other nation represented. So, amen, I told Pastor I'm willing to partner with him, and I'm willing to come in and help at North Cleveland Church of God. Is that okay? Mommy Lane, dear, you think they're ready for me? They're ready? They're ready. I believe it. Amen. Amen. Pastor Mark said, Apostle, he always said the Apostle. The last time they wrote a check to God's Lighthouse, said, Apostle Dr. Kenneth Morning said, God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries. Amen. Glory to God. And so it was important. Amen. And like I shared with them, I said, listen, I'm mentoring Pastor Sandra Dana. I call her pastor because she's taking on the mantle of her father, so then she can come into her full-time ministry, because she can't shift until she takes on that mantle and wear the cloak and things are in order. Amen. Right, Pastor? Yeah, that part. I know you didn't catch it yet. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. So this is important. Amen. Glory to God. So we go from Joseph, then we go to who? Glory to God, from Joseph to Esther to Ruth to Daniel. And the last person that represents the millennial generation is Mary, the mother of Christ. Amen. She was a young woman, but Elizabeth recognized the anointing on Mary. He said, how is that the mother of my Lord come to visit me? Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. I remember when I came here to Cleveland, Tennessee, I met my Elizabeth. Amen. Glory to God. And Mom Dana said, I know you. Amen. And so the Lord allowed me to think about, amen, Miss Regina Issa. When I started God's Lighthouse, she was on our board. She was the one who cleaned this place, decorated, not up here, but next door. Amen. She decorated all the prophetic word. 3 months, like I'm mentoring Pastor Sandra to birth her baby. For 3 months, I told her, every Monday I need to meet with you. Amen. Glory to God. So I'm decreeing and declaring that the Lord's of the Dream Center that they are called to build, we will help you guys, help them to build it. Amen. But we have to recognize who the apostles and elders are so we can pass the baton properly. Amen. Glory to God. And to what Revelation chapter 7 says, people from every nation, tribe, and tongue, their robes are washed in the blood of the Lamb, and they were wearing white robes. And the question was asked, where did these people come from? He said, these are they who came out of great tribulation. Amen. So we have to be ready. I told Mom Dana, she told me she had a vision. There were 3 babies, amen, that she saw. There were dark-skinned, black babies, you want to put it that way, amen. My son Isaac was kidding, peach and brown, amen. So they were brown skin, and she saw them. So I told her that those 3 children are my children, and the Lord says, give. So now she said, call me Grandma Dana. Is that okay? That's good. And my daughter said, okay, amen, amen. Because you know what happens? Amen. It's important that it goes 2 ways. One hand can't clap. Amen. Try to clap with one. It's not going to happen. It's beating the air. Amen. So we have to make sure that we are respecting one another. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. My son used to call the whites peach people. Amen. Because they don't look white. In his mind, as a pure child, he just saw it. They're like, can you use the white? He said, no, let me do the peach people. Glory to God. So we have to keep hearts pure. Is that good? Right. So we're just going to call people people. Amen. Just honor people, honor them. But we know that they're brown skin. And we know in society, their codes, they are black, white, Asian, European, African, all of that. But we never want to dismiss, amen, the process of the people. Amen. Glory to God that we're around. So I believe that, amen, we are ready to bond together. Amen. And then we have, so Mary conceived by Jesus by the Holy Spirit. And that's what we're working with. The Holy Spirit, the person of the Holy Spirit, seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us. That's the theme for rebuilding the tabernacle of David, to have a heart after God. Let God is your will. Amen. Praise God. Then we go to the generation Z. That's my children. And in a moment, all three of them are going to come. I think I'm going to say in order. Micah, you ready? Micah is going to come first. Then Isaiah, then Alana, amen. They're going to come in a moment and they're going to do their rendition. Glory to God, amen. Whatever God has put on their hearts, amen. Glory to God, amen. As we are building the tabernacle, these are the pillars and elders of God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries. Always want to make sure that their lives are, amen, always honored. They are Clevelanders. They were born here in Cleveland, Tennessee. Just like Joseph had his two sons born in Egypt so God could help him to move forward. Amen. Just like Moses has his sons that were born away from Pharaoh. Amen. Glory to God. So that's important. So when we think about the generation Z, the Lord said, think about David. So when my children, and I saw them all of last week, 7 days. Today's the 8th day, like David is the 8th child of Jesse. When I see how hard they worked, my God, and they began to sing and honor God, I was like, Lord, it's finished. So today is the sealing and signing where I get to sit down a lot more now and they do the work. Praise the Lord, but I don't get to sit down. I get to sit down in Tennessee because my husband is coming in. Amen. So I'm able to now do evangelistic work to the nations. Amen. As a, you know, an apostle touches all offices. So wherever I fit in, I just move along, amen, with the Lord. So think about David. It took a while to find David, amen. And so when you think of my children and those who are born between 1995 to 2012, that's the generation Z. Then the 7th generation is the generation Alpha from 2013 to 2025. So Kingdom Takeover Apostolic Gathering will be March 10th to the 17th next year. Okay, so make sure y'all book, get yourself cleared out. Amen. Take 7 days off. Right, my pastor and apostle? Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Listen, I wanted to say this. If pastor and apostle weren't here, I couldn't fully rest in and get things accomplished like I did. I'm telling you, only the Lord allowed them to take and come the Thursday. Amen. Because it's so important for you to have somebody that's right there with you. So you don't have to be straining. Jesus had Peter, James, and John, particularly John. John was right next to Jesus. Why? Jesus allowed John to be there because John's mother and father supported John. Peter only had his father around. Amen? So you have to always have somebody who actually embraces you well-rounded. In your three, your Peter, James, and John, you have to know which one. The Bible said the mother of James and John came and said, "Can my sons of your right and your left." The Bible said that James and John was with their father Zebedee and just asked for partnership. So God has brought, amen, us into partnership, amen, and we have to partner. Amen, glory to God. So that's important. So the generation Alpha, 2013 to 2025, represents the generation Alpha. And you think about Solomon, King Solomon, who took over from David. So once I'm finished with 2025, I don't know how long the Lord will tell me to shift for the kingdom takeover. What other dates? I just know that by August of 2026 is the final time where all 203 nations that are represented here will have God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries planted in there through our Empire School of Discipleship Masterclass Certification Program, which is a part of God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries University Bible College and Theological Seminary. So having leaders through their different levels and ranks of study, we're able to get people in. Like Apostle preached last night, Apostle Jackson talked about certain sect of the Pharisees was teaching wrong doctrine. So there are different ranks of different people. Amen. So whether you're a bishop or a reverend, each denomination may give different names. For God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries, we do apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, we do bishops, and we do elders, we do ministers. Those are the names and offices that we represent, other than brothers and sisters. Amen. Come on. Which we are believers, and then we are called Christians. Is that okay? Amen. Want to make sure you get the terminology right. Amen. Glory to God. So that's important. So Solomon took over. And guess what? Solomon knew what it was to go through a pain because his mother, his brother had died before because David and his mom did adultery that affected the kingdom. So we see many identity crises between the millennial, between the generation Z and the generation Alpha right now. There's a struggle. Amen. And we can't lose them. So if you recognize, amen, that the Bible says when Solomon died, his son, Rehoboam, took over. And Rehoboam, when the elders told Rehoboam, listen to the people asked him, can you make our Lord lighter than what Solomon did? And we'll serve you. And the Bible said that Rehoboam listened to his friends rather than the elders. And he went ahead and said, my father gave you his finger. I'm going to give you my fist and my waist. And the people killed Rehoboam. So we can't get to the next generation and let them take over. No, the Alpha. Jesus Christ is the Alpha and the Omega. Amen. So we have to stay focused in the season to make sure we are locked in the things of God. Amen. So all those are the seven generations that we want to focus in on. And that's where I'm at. Amen. So 2025. I want to just end there for a moment, amen, to let you know that God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries serves as an apostolic hub, the place of established love and care for the nations, amen, the goal and mission in life under the leadership of the Almighty God, by the power of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, fulfilling the Great Commission is making disciples of all nations. So we are happy that you have taken the time to come and fellowship with us. We trust that you will feel exceptionally welcome and become a part of this church family. Coming up in the weeks to come, amen, you'll be hearing the clear announcement of the different set services that will be had here as we are allowing leaders that are birthing up their ministry to have and to use the apostolic hub, amen, so we can allow the church of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to be put in place properly. Amen. Glory to God. I was talking to Prophetess Ariel Sedloff. Go ahead and highlight her for a quick moment, please. Amen. Prophetess Ariel Sedloff. Amen. The Lord showed her an archangel here in the Apostolic Hub, and she texted this morning about her. Amen. She's on the screen. Glory to God. Yes. Amen. And she shared about the Lord giving her that word. Amen. I told her this is where she belongs so she can fully realized her baby of faith in action ministries and the prophetic anointing on her life. So I'm really excited for her. Amen. And so many others that I've helped to see them birth out their ministry properly because they have proper foundation and doctrine in the things of God. So as we are poised for a new experience in the Holy Spirit, our hope is that you will sing, pray, and participate with us. Jesus said, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. So let us begin to serve the Lord, amen, in the attitude of gratefulness and thanksgiving, as we are confident of this one thing, he that hath begun a good work in us is able to complete it unto the day of his appearing. God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries exists to spread the good news of Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, to nurture, equip, empower, and develop disciples in ministry, to establish, develop, and grow local churches throughout the world, to heal the sick and open the eyes of the blind worldwide, and occupy the world until our Savior returns. Our vision is ministering the body of Christ, passionately modeling the life of Christ Jesus through significant relationships with believers as well as seekers, to identify, prepare, and support believers as leaders who carry the ministry of the local church into the world, providing a place to encounter God in worship and a place of fellowship and encouragement. And so therefore, the leaders that have spoken, amen, want to honor the Lord for them, and those who have been connected to the kingdom take over. Let's begin to highlight a few of them. I want to thank God for those who spoke yesterday, Apostle Darren Fisher and Apostle Carlton Jackson, amen. Go ahead and highlight on the screen for me, please. Alana, highlight them on the screen, amen. Praise the Lord. Apostle Fisher and Apostle Carlton, amen, from amen, Cornerstone Church in Zion. Glory to God. I want to thank God for them. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. So that's a part of the vision, having been an apostolic hub. Also want to thank God for Bishop William Simpson III. who was a part with us. Glory to God. Amen. We also want to thank God for, amen, glory to God, Prophetess Eseni Helen, amen, of Nigeria, that was instrumental in making all these flyers possible. Amen. Also want to thank God for, glory to God, Pastor Michael Williams. Amen. My uncle, glory to God, of England. Thank God for him. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So to God be all the glory. Those have been the leaders that have participated with us through the Kingdom Takeover. We had a few of them that didn't get to come on. Glory to God. But also want to honor the Lord for Apostle Henry Mugarula Solomon. I want to thank God for him. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. As he was a part of Kingdom Takeover 3 years ago. Glory to God. All the way to the 17th. Glory to God. So thank God for his ministry. Amen. Out of Uganda. And also thank God for, amen, Apostle Paul, amen, out of Uganda, that Apostle Henry introduced me to. We want to thank God for him. Glory to God. Amen. Thank you so much. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Overall, we had two other leaders. Bishop Shane, let's honor him. Glory to God. Bishop Shane Calhoun. Amen. Glory to God. I know he's still under the weather, so... Amen. Glory to God. He sent a message this morning. We're going to continue to pray for him. But thank God for his life and ministry. He went to Dominican Republic. Amen. And just came back in a few days. And so he's going through a healing time. So keep him in prayer. Glory to God. Thank God for him. And also I want to thank God for Reverend Biney. Amen. Reg Biney out of Ghana. Amen. I know that amen. A few of the leaders online didn't get to come on this time, but I certainly want to highlight that. So that's the vision of God's Lighthouse. Thank you so much. Amen. So the ministry goal is prepare God's people for works of service of the body of Christ to be built up until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Amen. That's Ephesians 4, 12 through 13. To meet the need, to nurture, equip, empower, develop disciples, to feed, faithfully educate, entrepreneurial disciples, to heed, help, educate, elevate disciples, so we can lead, love, educate, activate disciples, the body of Christ united, touching every green, for global evangelism and discipleship, connecting the dots, people to God, forming the network of God's kingdom builders. Amen. As Isaiah 62 and 10 says, pass through the gates, prepare the way for the people, build up the highway, remove the stones and raise a banner for the nations. Amen. So we get to nurture believers and seekers to become disciples and leaders of the finished work of Christ Jesus as Savior and Lord. Serve as faithful witnesses to Christ's finished work on the cross and his resurrection by the transformative power of the Holy Spirit who leads and guides into all truth. To equip disciples as leaders and send them to reap the harvest of souls for the kingdom of God. To empower disciples through transformational servant leadership to operate under the authority of Christ Jesus globally in every sphere of influence, the family mountain, the religion, church mountain, education mountain, business mountain, government mountain, arts and entertainment mountain, and the media mountain. Then to develop disciples, yes, as leaders who reproduce after the complete process, to demonstrate the identity of new birth in Christ, embody evidence of the fruit of the Spirit, and birth for the gifts of the Spirit in the nations of the world. So we can amend, activate, mobilize, evangelize, nurture disciples as leaders until the kingdoms of this world become the kingdoms of our Lord and Savior and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. So be mother, apostle to the nations, carrying and revealing Christ Jesus to the nations. I, president, founder, overseer, and visionary of God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries, Apostle Dr. Kenneth Solinson, want to just welcome all of you around the world, apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, bishops, elders and ministers, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, mothers and fathers, believers and seekers in Jesus Christ. I bless you in the name of Jesus. Amen. And you can sow into this ministry. It's scrolling across your screen. Amen. Glory to God. The Zelle, the PayPal, glory to God, the Cash App, and also to our secured website, you're able to sow a seed financially to this ministry, or you can come and bring it here, 310 20th Street, Southeast Cleveland, Tennessee, 37301. Please send us a text or an email. The phone number, 423-740-2992. Make sure we respond back to your email, GLTIM Apostolic Hub nuture@gmail.com. We certainly want to continue to serve and to help you to be strengthened in your most holy faith in Jesus' name. Shall we pray? And then the next voices you'll be hearing is that of Elders and Pillars, amen, Micah Caden Hinkson, then Isaiah Frank Hinkson, then Alana Kadeen Hinkson. Glory to God. And immediately following, I'll come to just honor and to present the mic, amen, for a brief testimonial, amen, from Mom Elaine Daner, and right standing with her will be Pastor Sandra Daner. They'll be sharing, and then we're going to be preparing for, amen, the communion, and then the message for today is going to be this great duo tag teaming, amen. Glory to God as you're preparing to depart today, amen. Pastor Dejan Staple and Apostle Junior Staple, they're going to be sharing. Thank God for their ministry. This year is going to be 3 years old. Jesus trained his disciples, who he named apostles, for 3 years. So thank God, this is their time and season. I'm going to be listening to them, whatever God has put on their heart. And thereafter, I will come to wrap it up from the upper room as we prepare, amen, to see them go off, amen, hallelujah, and leave us in good standing, amen, and seem good to the Holy Spirit and to us, amen, glory to God. And later on this evening, I'll come. We're going to be here in the broadcast room right below where I'm standing, and I'm going to share a final word for this Kingdom Takeover Apostolic Gathering. And if you don't get to come back, it's okay, but I need to do a final word, amen, from the house. Glory to God. I know Bishop Shane texted this morning that he's still not feeling well. Glory to God. So, amen, I wanted to make sure that I still lock in, especially that Mom Elaine Daner came today. Only God could have done that, that you're here. So whatever we needed to clear up, because the Lord told me something very clear. I've been in Cleveland, Tennessee for 20 years, like Jacob. Jacob was building Bethel, the house of God, and the Bible said that the Lord showed him how to get the poplar stick and set it before the sheep, the black ones and the white ones and the spotted. So the Lord has been showing me how to do that, how to turn and get the stronger ones. I don't need any weaklings on the front line with me. I need strong people that understand the anointing on my life. I'm not here to play games, amen. I'm here to make sure everybody gets what they want. I am tired of seeing leaders who have gone before us. Their sons and daughters are on the streets, struggling on drugs, locked up, all these different things. Why? Because the baton was not passed on properly, amen. Glory to God, amen. Shall we pray? Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ, by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of our testimony. Lord, thank you so much for your grace and your mercy and your love. Lord, I just want to thank you so much for consecrating my life, for allowing the crooked path to be made straight, for bringing mountains down, valleys up, making level path for my feet. And so on this eighth day of the Kingdom Takeover Apostolic Gathering, just like David was the eighth child, he was the youngest. Lord, thank you so much for putting everything into place, Father God. Thank you for blessing my life, blessing my family, my husband, your servant, your son, Lord, Mr. Frenchie Hinkson. Thank you, dear God, for blessing our children, Alana, Isaiah, Michael Hinkson. Thank you for blessing every speaker and every leader that have graced the platform for the Kingdom Takeover. For those who have been streaming online, Lord, your people are coming into alignment from Jerusalem, all Judea, Samaria, to the ends of the earth. We speak blessing and grace. I speak blessing and grace. Thank you for using me for your glory, for your praise, and for your honor. In Jesus' name. Can we say in Jesus' name? In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Go ahead and come, Micah. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
With every breath that I am able.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, I will sing.
Hallelujah.
Of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire and darkest night. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Oh, my God.
Welcome to God's Fair's Tabernacle International Ministries. I'm Solikov, the place we establish loving care for the nation's kingdom takeover. I'm Yakison, and today I'll be reading Proverbs 4 and reading whatever I feel. Listen, my son, to the father's instruction. Pay attention and gain understanding. I give you sound learning. Do not forsake my teaching. For I too was a son to my father, so tender and cherished by my mother. Then he taught me and said to me, take hold of my words with all your heart. Keep my commands and you will live. Get wisdom, get understanding. Do not forget my words or turn away from them. Do not forsake wisdom and she will protect you. Love her and she will watch over you. The beginning of wisdom is this, get wisdom. Though it costs all you have, get understanding. Cherish her, she will exalt you. Embrace her, she will honor you. She will give you a garland to grace your head and present you with a glorious crown. Listen, my son, accept what I say, and the years of your life will be many. I instruct you in the way of wisdom and lead you along straight paths. When you walk, your steps will be hampered. When you run, you will not stumble. Hold on to instruction. Do not let it go. Guard it well, for it is your life. Do not set foot on the path of the wicked or walk in the way of evildoers. Avoid it. Do not travel on it. Turn from it and go on your way. For they cannot rest until they do evil. They are robbed of sleep until they make someone stumble. They eat the bread of wickedness and drink the wine of violence. The path of the righteous is like the morning sun, shining ever brighter till the full light of day. But the way of the wicked is like deep darkness. They do not know what makes them stumble. My son, pay attention to what I say. Turn your ear to my words. Do not let them out of your sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life to those who find them and health to one's whole body. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. Keep your mouth free of perversity. Keep corrupt talk far from your lips. Let your eyes look straight ahead. Fix your gaze directly before you. Give careful thought to the past. To the pass forward your feet and be steadfast in all your ways. Do not turn to the right or the left. Keep your foot from evil. We know what God is saying. Amen.
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 I also wrote what verse I learned the notes from. A father's instructions will give you understanding. Verse 1. The beginning of wisdom is get wisdom. Verse 7. If you listen to what the Lord says, your life will be prolonged. Verse 10. Don't focus on where you went wrong, but what you can do right. Verse 18 through 19. And verse 11 says, I instruct you in the way of wisdom. And lead you along straight paths. And it reminded me of the verse that says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge it, and he shall direct your path.
Amen.
Evildoers won't rest until they inconvenience somebody else. Verse 16. Evildoers strive off wickedness and violence. Verse 17. Be careful when choosing what path you take and be steadfast in it. And that reminded me of a saying that says, don't go to the grocery store when you're hungry because you might grab the wrong thing.
Good job. That's a good one.
Amen. Don't just read God's word, but remember it first. 20 through 21. You sow what you reap. So guard your heart, verse 23. I'll now be inviting the saints.
Yes, amen. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. God. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Welcome to God's Lighthouse. Thank you for taking time out of your day to come worship with us. When you're playing the, I think it was the first song I played on the tenor, and I played quite a few times. I'm going to be playing a new song once we get down there in the evening.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Welcome to Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries. My name is Lighthouse, and I want to send you the honor slaves. Pastor Hayman.
Use my distance so I can walk.
Amen. Glory to God. Amen. 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 Thank you so much. Amen. I am a child of God. Glory to God. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. It's a beautiful song. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Can we give the Lord a hand clap for my amazing children? Hallelujah. I go into the upper room, and this is the time where birthing is taking place. The Bible says the mother of Jesus, along with the brothers of Jesus, they're in the upper room among the 120 when the nations came to Jerusalem. And I am looking, the Lord has shown me a vision that, amen, the reason why he gave me this location and the address, amen, I see a sea of people. I remember asking the Lord, where are these people coming from? And the Lord said, they walked here, they drove, I don't know where they parked, but this entire facility is going to be filled with people. Glory to God. Over the years, I've seen it, and this is the reason why this apostolic hub, amen, is being erected as the city of David. Glory to God. David got in among the Jebusites. Glory to God, amen, which is the family mountain. And so thank God for the opportunity, amen, that God is going to give. And I'm telling you, my husband is wrapping up everything that he needs to do. So, amen. So he wants to be here with his family. And once he comes in and does what God is finalizing with him, as the Lord has told us to join as one instrument, we're going to press in. Glory to God. Amen. Right before I invite these amazing servants of God to give their testimony, I want to actually share this word that God gave me for my husband and I, because the Lord wants me to read it again. Amen. I've read it often, but I want to read it again. Amen. So whenever you hear me speak, you know that I speak as one with my husband. Amen. Apostle and pastor. Amen. And teacher is the office that God has put him in. And also he has a great prophetic flow that God is building him up in the gifts. But the Lord gave me a word for my husband and I. Glory to God. From 2014, somebody gave us this word. Amen. The Lord dropped it in our house. And here's what the word says. I want to refer to it because I want to make sure everybody know that he's actually a part with me and I with him. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. I'm looking for it. Here it is. Here it is. Okay. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. It says, my servants, Kadeen and Frank. And if you notice, it says Kadeen and Frank, just like Mary and Joseph. Amen. It says, my servants, Kadeen and Frank, know that my, let me put it up bigger. Amen. Just a moment. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. He said, know that my hand is upon your life. You are one of many light posts which I have placed strategically abroad. Do not be discouraged for what it is all about, for it is only for a time. Remain steadfast and set your sight to that which is afar off, which will come upon you like lightning from an eastern sky. Join together as one instrument that I shall use to guide those who shall be saved. Demonstrate as you walk in my righteousness and flee from the worries of this world. Lean not to your own understanding, but listen to my voice and I shall guide you as to where you shall go, what you shall say, and what you shall do. Do not pattern yourself after others who have become mighty in the flesh, but their hearts are far from me. Measure not your success by the insignificant numbers, but rather find your importance in the few I have placed in your care. The few. Can we say the few? Amen. Many are called, but few are chosen. Yeah. Come on, somebody. Amen. Hallelujah. And he says also, walk and talk with me daily. seek my righteousness with a contrite and humble heart, and I will allow signs and wonders to follow in the path I lead you in. Demonstrate my love and compassion to family, friends, and all those I shall bring about you. And though you will not see the fruit of your action for some time, it will come to pass. Know that my rain falls on the fallow ground, and I shall use you to turn it. Continue to trust me, and desire for the deep and great revelation shall be open unto you. And know that my love for you endures without end. Amen. And this prophetic word was given, this was laminated, given to us on November 3, 2014. Amen. So we've been waiting on the Lord. We've been here 20 plus years, been married 23 plus years. August 11th coming is going to make 23 years we've been married. And so, amen. Glory to God. We're just pressing in. Amen. Glory to God. And we know that by 2025, everything will be completely wrapped in, so we can shift that by 2026. Amen. All nations we were brought in because of what God is doing supernaturally in and through my life. So just hearing my children today, Micah, didn't he do great? Minister the word. Micah and Isaiah playing the music. Amen. As he promised you another song later on this week. Amen. But show up, the Crab family. My husband loved that song. Amen. We listened to it all night. One night he came. We said, I just want to hear that song. Amen. And the goodness of God. Amen. And Alana singing. Oh, I just love it. Alana, thank you for singing that song. I hope we get to sing it later. I told her, it was so nice to hear her say last night, I'm happy that y'all enjoy my singing. So thank God for her. Amen. So right now, we're going to invite, amen, the beautiful, beautiful family. Amen. Our whole generation that's here. Mom Elaine Daner is going to come with Pastor Sanja Daner. So Pastor, make sure you stand beside Mommy. Amen. Come, Mom. Amen. Glory to God. Come and stand beside your mom. Yes, come on. Yes. Amen. Glory to God. So I want to thank God for the great woman of God. I had the great honor to sit in our home recently. Glory to God. And to just to share, amen, this time. And we sat down. We talked a lot. We hugged. We laughed. Amen. We didn't do any crying. I think Pastor Sanja did the crying. She did, yes, a little bit here and there.
I knew all that.
But I really honor the Lord for the beauty of over 15 plus years. She remembers me. Amen.
Yes.
And I just want to tell you how much I love you. Amen. Thank you so much. Amen. So here is Mommy Lane Daner and Pastor Sanja Daner, her daughter. Thank God for being here today. Here you go.
I thank the Lord to be here with Apostle Dr. Aideen Gibson. It's good to be here. And I guess I want to speak on how my life began or started with the Lord. I was brought up in the Church of God. We attended four times a week to worship the Lord at our church. I learned to pray when I was young. I learned at 3 years old. Mother found me in the kitchen, in the corner of the kitchen, on my knees praying. Mm-hmm. And then at 6 years old, we had an old barn, and that was my church. And I worshiped the Lord at six, and I felt the presence of the Lord. And at 12, when I was 12 years old, we were in revival, and Mother always prayed around the altar with other people giving their hearts to the Lord. And I said to Mother, you go and pray around the altar. And Mother, I will sit here with my brothers. I was the oldest. And Mother said, no, Elaine, it's your time to go to the altar.
Wow.
I will sit with the boys.
Wow.
So I went at 12, I went to the altar and gave my heart to the Lord. We were in revival. And in that revival, the Lord saved me, sanctified me, and filled me with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
And so from 12 years old to 13, I began to pray for the Lord's will for my life. And then at 13, I began to pray for the right spouse.
Amen.
When God got ready. And so at 16 and a half, I was dating a young man from our church. He was 11 years older than me. But I was dating him, and he asked me if I would marry him. And I said, well, you know, I have to ask my parents. And he said, of course, I'll take care of that. So he talked to my dad and my mother, and my dad said yes. My mother said, I'll think about it. So I knew what her answer was no. I was young, and I was oldest, and I helped her around the house and taking care of three brothers and a sister. So she really needed me at home, and I was too young to get married. So she didn't say yes. So I learned later that my husband-to-be prayed and fasted. And he came over after church and on Sunday, and he taught Sunday school, and he was led worship at the church. And he came over to sit with me when I was sick. I had high fever. I was on the couch. I was very sick. He came over to sit with me until that evening, before, so he'd go back to church that evening. And before he went, he told my mother, he said, it's time for me to go and leave and go to church. And my mother, he said to my mother, let's pray for Elaine before I leave. So they both got down on their knees and they prayed. And when they were getting up, mother, tears were running down her face, a fountain of tears. And she looked at my husband, David L. Daner, to be. She looked at him and said, David, I give my consent for you and Elaine to be married.
Amen.
Because, she said, if I don't, the Lord is going to take her. So she gave her consent. The Lord had spoke to her. And so then, the next day, Monday, I was well, as if I had never been sick.
Mm, hallelujah.
So that started our time to be married.
Yes.
And planning for the wedding. We had a beautiful wedding.
Amen.
And I just thank the Lord for our life, and the Lord, he was called into ministry.
Yes.
We went and began to evangelize for a year, and then we went to pastor the rest of our married life.
Amen.
So I thank the Lord for his calling, for his blessing.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Thank
Go
you.
Ahead, Pastor. Bye, yes. Mom. We the people.
Thank the Lord.
Amen.
I thank the Lord for being here today.
Yes.
This is a blessing.
Go ahead and share that. Yes. Yes.
A blessing.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
I don't know where to take it from there, because
just
that was
honor,
good.
Yeah, just honor your mom and honor the fact, yes.
Well,
and
I
mom, think... Mom, did you want to honor what God is doing with Pastor Sandra?
Yes.
Give it back to
Sandra
mom.
has a calling. And she's wanting to leave out of America. And I haven't had much to say. Because every time she says something about it, you know, mother worries. And every time she said something about it, I say, Lord, I give it to you. I give it to you. Every time, I give it to you. So we want things to go according to the Lord's will.
Amen.
For Sandra to answer her call.
Amen.
So,
praise God. Amen.
Yes, I give it back to Sandra.
Amen.
Thank you. I'm sitting over there about ready to cry.
Amen.
And she told that story. I just felt it. And then she says that. And then because... Actually, there's a lot of people that said, I want to hear your opinion. And I said that to my mom. I don't want to hear your opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Because I can't hear God's voice. If I hear your opinion and I hear someone else's opinion, I need to hear from God right now. And I can't hear the opinions of my kids right now. I can't hear your opinion. I can't hear a lot of people's opinion, because a lot of people had opinions. And to hear from God, I had to hear from him. And I kind of just had to, I shut everybody down for a while.
Amen.
So
stay put.
That story, again, I've heard that story, but today it just really touched me, the story about mom and dad.
I have a lot of other stories.
Yeah. Amen. Praise God.
Of course you do. You've lived 81 years.
Yes.
You have a lot of stories.
Yes.
Amen. I just want to say this, amen, from Pastor Sandra, because she didn't want to hear mom's opinion, but now she heard mom's concerns.
Amen.
Amen. There's a difference.
That's different.
Yes, amen. Praise God. So today, amen, just like with my husband, if my dad didn't approve of my husband, I would not have married my husband, no matter how much he said he loved me. Amen. So it's always important to get the blessing of your parents.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. In anything you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. The Bible says, honor your father and mother, which is the first one of the promise, that your days may be long upon the earth. So Pastor Sandra, I'm really excited today. Amen. That mom, the Lord, because she kept giving it to the Lord concerning you, she was able, after her surgery last week,
mm-hmm.
amen, she was able to make it here, amen, to honor the fact of her husband that she received from the Lord to do ministry, now to bless you.
Yes.
Amen. And I shared with mom, Mom Dana, amen, glory to God, that we're going to prepare. Pastor Sandra is going to be preparing to travel with Apostle Junior Staple and Pastor Dejan Staple in their vehicle as we're preparing her to transition for Togo, Africa. Amen. And then guess what happened? We're going to bring her back up. But when Pastor Sandra is leaving for Togo, Africa, God's willing, I'll be taking along mom with her so we can see her off properly. Amen. Because we have to do things right.
Amen.
Amen. We heard how Pastor David Daner transitioned to meet the Lord. It was a quick move right away. So in 1995. So my responsibility, I came to the United States in 1995. So I have to stay focused. And 1995 is the beginning of the Generation Z, which is the David generation. So I can't play around. So I have been diligent. Pastor Sandra, she registered for the Empire School of Discipleship Masterclass. I've been mentoring and training her. And I know that she's really excited that we have loved on her. I mean, she have all of her brown-skinned melatonin brothers and sisters. and sometimes she don't know when to like zip it, zap it, and put it in her pocket. Amen. Because she's been excited. She's been there. And I'm not saying a mean way, I said in a good way. But because what happened? She's been excited that we stood with her. She's been happy. She's been helping to take pictures. She's been helping to amen, to make sure every guest that comes in, she's been doing well. And so thank God for Pastor Dejan and Apostle, amen, that came. And she get to meet my best friend from high school. This is how awesome it is, amen, for her to now know she's accepted in the beloved. And mom, even now we are family.
Yes.
Amen.
We are
a family together for the Lord, standing here in Cleveland, Tennessee.
Yes.
Thank you for standing and waiting till I arrive.
We were supposed to meet when we did.
That's right.
How many years ago?
Over 15 years ago.
15 years ago.
Yes. Amen.
You know something I thought was really neat too? Your maiden name is Williams.
Correct.
And my son's middle name is William.
That's
William, not a Williams.
Gotcha.
William.
Yes. Uh-huh. And like I said, they're both came from North Cleveland Church of God. Like I shared with Pastor Dr. Mark Williams, I said, because my maiden name was Williams and his name is Williams, the Lord said we should join together and partner, amen, so North Cleveland Church of God, amen, can be realigned as God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries, being an apostolic of the apostles and elders are together. If apostles and prophets are not in place, pastors and teachers cannot go forward, and evangelists cannot go forward properly. So we must have the fivefold that Christ gave to the church, Ephesians 4:11. So I'm really excited. Mom, can you pray for us? Amen.
Father God, we come to you, Father.
Yes, Lord.
You are our Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
We come in the name of Jesus, your Son. Lord, we just pray your blessings, Lord God, on this ministry.
Thank you, Jesus.
On this ministry, Lord. And all that are involved in this ministry. We just, hallelujah, we just pray, Lord God, your blessings, that it will grow multiply. Lord, that people will be touched. People will be blessed. People will come to know you as their Savior. We thank you, Lord Jesus,
thank you, Jesus,
for giving your life for us.
Thank you, Jesus.
That you loved each one of us all the same. Not one better than the other, but you love us all.
Thank you, Jesus.
We give you thanks, Lord.
Thank you.
Again, we pray for your blessings, Lord, on Apostle Kedin Vincent, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
We pray your blessings on her, Lord, as she spurs this ministry on. We pray for your blessings to all that are involved. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Can we say we receive?
Receive.
Amen. Thank you so much. I love you. Amen. Thank you so much. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to do communion and then we're going to prepare for the message. Amen. Pastor and Apostle, you ready? Amen. Amen. They're ready. Amen. Because guess what? They have to fly out of here in the Holy Ghost. Amen. Glory to God. So I'm excited to hear the word today. Hallelujah. We're going to have communion. Y'all know every Sunday I love to do communion. Amen. Jesus says, often as you do it until he comes. And so the Bible says, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene went to the sepulcher. And she was a woman who, according to Luke 8, seven demons was delivered from her. Amen. Glory to God. So we want to make sure people, when you're receiving communion, you're receiving the deliverance of the Lord. Thank you. Glory to God. So the God be all the glory for the great things he has done. Amen. Glory to God. As we're serving the Lord in spirit and in truth, we're going to take our prescription. Amen. Glory to God. So Mom Dana, we're going to make sure you carry home as many communion cups with you. So you do communion as often as the Lord reveals. Amen. Praise the Lord. Sometimes I do communion daily, sometimes several times a day. Like the doctor would say, you know, if he would give you prescription, say take three times a day, four times a day. Well, the Lord said, every time something comes inside you, he says, hey, every now and then I said, go do communion again. Sometimes I do two, three, four times a day. Do communion. Why? Because I'm taking my prescription and the body and the blood of Christ settles in me. In him I live and move and have my being. Amen. Glory to God. So let us bless the communion. Amen. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I come to you. Amen. Amen. Heavenly Father, Lord, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ, by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of our testimony, Lord Jesus. Thank you for your body that has been broken for us, Lord. You are wounded for transgressions. You are bruised for iniquity. The chastisement for our peace is upon you, and by your stripes you are healed. Lord, thank you, dear God, that healing is a children's bread. And like the woman, oh God, that came on the behalf of her daughter, she said, even the crumbs of the master's table is enough, Lord, under the master's table. Lord God, Lord, they were called Gentile dogs. And God, we thank you. We thank you that even David, when he was hungry, took the bread from off the altar. And Lord, others, oh God, was complaining about it. But Lord, you brought the scripture to place. David, glory to God, ate the bread, hallelujah, because the hallelujah, the altar and the house that has the bread, hallelujah, you are the Lord. You are the bread of life. You are the blood sacrifice atoning, oh God, for our sins upon the cross. Lord, we thank you that the blood that flows through our veins, to those of us who accepted and believe and confess in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and those who are coming into the fold to believe upon the Lord Jesus Christ and are saved, Lord, we are able to participate in the fruit of the vine, because you are the vine, we are the branch. So every branch in you that bears fruit, you prune it. So thank you for the pruning in our lives, oh God, and thank you that our bodies are your temple and you're rebuilding the temple, Lord of God, that we have people after your own heart, Lord God, to serve you in spirit and truth. So bless us, thank you for forgiving us all sins and unrighteousness. He said, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, walk not after the flesh and after the spirit. So God, we give you praise and honor in Jesus' name. Amen. The Bible said on the same night when Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he took it and said, this is my body that I've been broken for you. Can you break the bread? Amen. Hallelujah. And say, Lord Jesus, I receive this bread, and that my body is your temple. That in you I live, move, and have my being. And that my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. So have your way in me as I receive this bread for your glory and for your praise. Amen. Let's receive the prescription of the body of Christ in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And Matthew 26 continues. He took the cup and he said, this is the covenant, new covenant in my blood. Hallelujah. He did the Last Supper and communion was apart. When the brethren gathered in Jerusalem, the Bible said when 3,000 were added to the church in a day, they devoted some to the apostles' teaching and doctrine and the breaking of bread, and they went from house to house. So it's very, very important to understand receiving the cup. So Lord Jesus, thank you for your blood that was shed for me. Your word declares that without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. So I receive the fruit of the vine, that every ligament, tendons, and tissue in my body, from the crown of my head to the soles of my feet, that, Lord, I'll walk and talk in your divine will for your glory in Jesus' name. Let's receive the cup in Jesus' name. Amen. I'm telling you, I love to take communion. I don't know about you. Amen. Praise God. I feel good. Amen. Hallelujah. Can we just say hallelujah? Can we say thank you, Jesus? Can we say hallelujah? Glory to God. I'm going to invite the servants of the Lord to come to join me here at the, amen, glory to God, here at the podium. I am truly, truly honored and delighted and thankful and overwhelmed and overjoyed. Amen. Glory to God to present. Glory to God. Hallelujah to all of you around the world that are watching from North America to South America to Africa to Asia to Europe to Australia, Oceania. Listen, amen. We're going to include Antarctica, the continent. Amen. Because the angel of the Lord encampered about them that fear him. I want to thank God. Amen. Go ahead. Glory to God for Pastor Dejan Staple, glory to God, and Apostle Junior Staple, amen, Refuge and Restoration International Ministries, glory to God. Come on in, amen, glory to God. I want to thank God for them, thank God for the diligence and the faithfulness, amen. I know Pastor Deji shared her story with me, amen, that she was, amen, as the Lord told her to get ready and prepare the ministry, glory to God, hallelujah, and she found the name that Apostle Junior Staple received for the name of the ministry. Amen. They couldn't find it at first, and then one day, all of a sudden, she could tell you the story better than I can. Amen. But the Lord allowed her to locate it, and then they registered the ministry. And amen. Thank God to be a part of being an apostle and serving. Amen. Serving them and to see that they can go forth in greater fullness. So right here from Cleveland, Tennessee, from Jerusalem. Amen. For God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries, I want you to welcome, give a warm welcome. Can you give the Lord a hand clap for them? Apostle Junior Staple and Pastor Dejan Staple, in Jesus' name. God bless you.
Amen. 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 Blessed, blessed. Good evening, everyone. Thanks God again for this platform that we're here in Cleveland, Tennessee, God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministry. We honor the leader of this ministry, my friend from 28 years, Apostle Claudine Hinson.
Amen.
We give God thanks for her and her family for one more time to be here in the house to give God all that he has deserved.
Amen.
So we are here, just want to honor him with everything that we do and in every means that we have. We just want to continue to glorify God this morning.
Amen.
As I'm here in representing the Ministry Refuge and Restoration International Ministry, all the way out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, we just honor God for everything that he's doing in Refuge. And we doesn't take it lightly that he has called us into this capacity of being a pastor or a leader over the people that he has placed with us. So we take it as honor that he has called us there, and we will do our best diligently to make sure that we are walking and doing what God has us to do. So we just honor God today for all that he is doing in our life and for our children and for the leaders that are in our ministries.
Yes.
We just want to honor God for them that they stand with us, the Longstreet family, Connor and Nathan Longstreet. We honor God for you too, that you continue to stand with us in whatever God has us to do. And I give God thanks for my children Dejon, Cajun, and Jerikai Henley. We just thank God for them as they continue to press into what God has called them to do. The struggle is real, but they are standing and doing what God had them to do. So we honor God for them all today for continuing to stand with us in our ministry, Refuge and Restoration International, and as well as the other leaders and ministers that are in the ministry. We just honor God for them as well as they will be coming in. So God, we thank you for all that you're doing for us and with us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For the name of our ministry, as we got the name, it, as Apostle said before, I gave her the rundown a little, is that Apostle, my husband, the Lord has blessed him with that name for a while, and he wrote it down on an envelope and put it away. And, you know, the Lord has been preparing him to move with the ministry, but he's been holding on and, you know, decided that he's waiting. Until one day I was at home and the Lord bid me to do what he have asked him to do, and he refuses to. So the Lord tell me, because we've been looking for the name to register, because the Lord has been preparing us to register the business, the name of the ministry and move with it. But he had put the name away and couldn't find it. And the Lord bid me one day where to go and search for it. I had no idea where he put it, but the Lord just instruct me and where to go and look for it. And so said, the name was right there in that envelope, looking at us all this time. The name was there on the envelope. But because it wasn't time for us to find it until God says so, he opened up my spiritual eyes and I was able see where he has that name placed in. And from there, I registered the ministry without he even know. I registered the ministry. One day he said to me, babe, it's time to register. I said, you're late. I said, you're late because it's been registered. So I registered the business, the ministry name,
yes,
and I have it there and just waiting and hoping and praying the day when he will say, okay, let us make that move.
Yes.
Because he was holding on into a ministry that wasn't benefit him what God wants him to do. So I give God thanks for the day that he opened his eyes to say, okay, it is time to move. So when he get the call that it's time to move, it was ready and in marinating, well seasoning,
that's
and
right,
ready to go. So I give God thanks for that. And once we decide to take the move and do what God asked us to do, everything else flows right into
my
position.
God.
So we were able to do, the Lord blessed us with somewhere where we're able to do our worship. We're able to fellowship as one, as family, and we continue to progress. We were in our wilderness situation.
That's right.
We went through our Israel situation. We have been to different places, from our living room, from the patio, from the park, sitting on benches.
That's
bench
right.
Hopping. We were like, you could pavilion hopping. People comes when they want their pavilion. We move and go and sit on the grass.
Yes.
We were sitting on the pavement and we were doing whatever God asked us to do. We were pushing and going forward until he opened up a building for us and we were able to sit on comfortable chair and worship him. But we have no regrets in our wilderness situation that God has gave us. It was an experience and it was a blessing. And today of that, we just continue to push forward and do what God has us to do. And so we are here at this time, all the way in Cleveland, Tennessee. This is one more elevation that the Lord has placed upon us.
One more elevation.
And we are continuing to push into what God has for us
to
do. There is no looking back. We are only looking forward because God has our back. So whatever is behind us stays behind us.
That's
because
right.
God wants us to stay focused. So we're putting on that muzzle and we're continuing to move forward what God has for us. So as Refuge and Restoration International Ministry move nationwide, we continue to hold on to what God
Praise
has for us.
God.
So we have no delay, no shifting, but we just continue to walk forward and push forward in what God has for us to do in the name of Jesus. Thank you. At this time, I will call up the apostle, no other than my husband, Apostle Dr. Junior Stable. Welcome him as he come in this time.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. Amen.
Thank you very much, my pastor, and thank you for telling the nation how disobedient I was to the Lord. after he gave me the name, and I delay. But we know that according to the word of God, that all things work together for good to those of us who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. And we thank God for every delay that we have been through. It's for a good reason and it's for a purpose. We leave shortly to the airport because we have to go back home. Amen. But we want to say thanks to the Mother Apostle for accommodating us for the days that we're here. And we had a capoeira stand.
That's right. Yeah. Yes, we have.
We had a capoeira stand. It was good because to leave home for 4 days and to be with the apostle, it's good.
Yes.
We learned a lot. We learn and we meet a lot of people.
Yes.
Because that's the way the Father has planned it.
Yes.
And we can only do what he wants us to do.
Amen.
No matter how much we delay,
that's right.
We still have to take our Jonah
experience
and come back right to where the Lord would have us to be.
In
my closing
sermon
message, today,
message.
Where
yes.
I am not going to preach no homiletical sermon. I'm just going to bring a message, no three-pointer. And nothing like that, just a message.
Amen.
And it's found in Acts of the Apostle, chapter 50.
That's right.
And the first one, that's where the message is today.
Yes.
And certain men came down from Judea and thought the brethren, unless you are circumcised according to the custom of Moses, you cannot be saved. Lord God, we ask that you honor your words and bless your words into our hearts and glorify your name. In Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Unless you are circumcised, hallelujah, according to the custom of Moses, you cannot be saved. We know that there's another misunderstanding and misinterpretation and missaying in this.
Yes.
Particular word here, unless we are circumcised with the circumcision of Moses, we cannot be saved. That's kind of contrary to what we know, because according to the word of God, hallelujah, Jesus Christ says in John 14, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Right.
No man cometh unto the Father but by me. And salvation is to be found in the acceptance of Jesus Christ, whose blood was shed upon the cross of Calvary to redeem the entire world. According to John 3 and verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And the verse 17 goes on to say, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Not being saved through the custom of Moses and the circumcision of the Jews, which had to be physically circumcised to be a Jew. You're a Jew as a man, a male. You're a Jew according to what is to be found in Deuteronomy. You are a Jew after circumcision, after 8 days of birth. But now Jesus Christ says that your salvation is wrapped up in me.
That's right.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Hallelujah. Circumcision then that God requires now is not that of the Jew, but of your heart. Rend your heart and not your garment. What is found in 1 Corinthians 10 from verse 32 to 33. Give no offense, the word of God says, to the Jews, nor to the Gentile, nor to the church of God. Become the church of God, yeah. Jews or Gentile can become the church of God through the acceptance of Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
Yes.
Through, hallelujah, kneeling down, standing up, driving in your car, accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, and thou shalt be saved. Give no offense.
Yeah.
Don't worry about where you are and who you are once you are in Christ. Because unless Christ builds a house, they labor in vain that builds it. Unless your life is wrapped up in Jesus Christ, your life must be hidden in Christ, in God, so that you know that you have eternal life. Eternal life then is not to be found in the circumcision of your foreskin, but eternal life is to be found in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When you accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, you have eternal life.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. It's not your action. Hallelujah. But it's your reason. Reasonable service. When you kneel down before the Lord and said, I surrender all to Jesus. I surrender all to him. I freely give. I will ever love and trust him. In his presence daily live. I'm going to walk and talk with Jesus
right.
each and every day
right.
because I want my life to be an example. As Paul said to Timothy, the young minister, be thou an example of the believers so that people will see, hallelujah, your lifestyle and pattern your lifestyle and live according to the dictates of the word of God and yield yourself to the Lord Jesus Christ and let him lead you by his spirit.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We are now being led as children of God by the Spirit of God that takes over our life. When we kneel and accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, the Spirit of God comes and dwells in you, hallelujah, and teach you how to live. So we sing the song, lead me, guide me along life's way, Lord God. Because if you lead me, I won't go astray. Lord, let me walk each day with you because I want to walk and talk with Jesus every day because I want my life to be an example.
That's right. Come on. Come on.
Hallelujah. There is no fear in the desert. There is naught to fear in the desert here if you allow Jehovah to lead you. Because we are pilgrims passing through this barren land. We are pilgrims. Hallelujah. We are heavenly people. Hallelujah. Passing through this earthly vessel. We have this earthly vessel because we are living on the earth.
That's right.
And that is why we have this flesh. But we are not of this world. As the word of God says, that we must be circumcised in our heart. Hallelujah. Surrendering to the Lord. Giving the Lord your heart. Giving him everything. And surrender your life to him.
Amen.
It doesn't matter where you are. It doesn't matter what nationality you are from. As long as you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you are heaven bound and you're bound to heaven. So whether Your foreskin is torn off or not. Once you accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you're bound forever.
Amen.
As long as you heal yourself, as long as you heal your body, your mind, your soul to the Lord, you are heaven bound.
That's right.
There is nothing to worry about. There's nothing to be afraid of. Because when you accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, all fears were gone. As long as you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, there is no need to be afraid. I no longer live in fear. Hallelujah, because Jesus Christ has set me free, and whom the Son set free is free indeed. I'm no longer bound. Hallelujah, no more chain holding me, because Jesus Christ has set me free. And the Word of God says, whom the Lord God set free is free indeed. And we should not go back, hallelujah, be entangled again in the yoke of bondage, but we should stand fast in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free, and be free indeed.
Amen.
Whether you are Jews, you're Gentile, whether you're bound or you're free, as long as you accept Jesus Christ as your Savior, you are bound forever. You are ever bound, because Jesus Christ is the door. Hallelujah. And he said it in his word according to John 14, that he is the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. There is no other way to heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah. No other way to heaven but to accept Jesus Christ. No matter what religion you're from, no matter what religion, be you a Buddhist or wherever you're from, you need Jesus Christ in your life to go to heaven. You cannot go to heaven unless you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. So you can go and circumcise even your eye if you want to. Circumcise your lips. But without Jesus Christ in your life, you have no need to worry about going to heaven.
That's right.
I am the way,
the truth, and the life.
The truth and the life.
No one comes to the Father.
No man can come unto the Father
but
through me. I am the door. Yes. Hallelujah. Through which all enter. Because remember, the word of God tells you that the thief only come to steal and to destroy. Hallelujah. But I am come that you might have life, and have life more abundantly.
Yes.
Jesus Christ came so that we could have life, abundant life. Jesus Christ came so that we will escape the wrath that is to come.
That's right. Amen.
We know the wrath.
Hallelujah.
We know, hallelujah, that every man without Christ is going to face this tribulation and go through the war that is ahead of us.
My God, tell us, Apostle.
Hallelujah. But because the church is the bride of Christ. Hello.
Amen. Come on.
The church is the bride of Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So in John 14, he says again, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I, Jesus, am,
come on,
you will be also. So Jesus Christ is coming back to fetch away the bride. Hallelujah. And we're going to meet him in mid here, according to 1st or 2nd Corinthians 14, where Christ says, I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren.
That's right.
Concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not according to others who have no hope. Because if you have Jesus Christ in your life, then he will come again and receive you unto himself, so that wherever he is, hallelujah, we will be also there. Let us work and pray for the rapturing of the church, so that we will be raptured and be with the Father. We will be where Christ is. We don't know what we shall be, but we know that when we see him, we shall see him as he is, and we shall be like him.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
So forget about religion. Let us forget about religion. Let us concentrate on salvation. Let us concentrate on salvation. Let us concentrate on the saving of my soul. Because I cannot swap my soul for anything else. I cannot swap my soul for no religion. I have to accept Jesus Christ and live for him. Hallelujah. I have to keep myself sanctified and holy. I have to circumcise my heart so that I will do his will and live according to the dictates of his words.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There is no two ways about it, people. There is no two ways. Right around this world, I want you to know today that there is no two way about your salvation. There is no two way about salvation. There is only one way to salvation. There is only one way to eternal life, and that is to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, and be baptized and live according to the word of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. No religious sect, hallelujah, can save you.
That's right.
No matter how we are, join and affiliate yourself with whatever denomination, unless you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are fighting a losing battle.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Unless you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are nowhere to be found in heaven, because you will be lost.
That's right.
Because Jesus Christ is the way. Jesus Christ is the truth. Jesus Christ is the light. You cannot accept no one else. Hallelujah. Paul won't save you. Although we look and we read the Pauline law, hallelujah, we read the words of Paul, but Paul cannot save you. You must turn to Jesus Christ. That God sent his son. God sent his son to save us from all our sins. And so we read in Galatians 4, I think it's verse 30, that when the fullness of time was come, hallelujah, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them which were under the law. So if you are under the law, accepting Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, free you from the bondage of the law.
That's right. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Hallelujah.
Let us kneel at the cross. Hallelujah. Christ will meet us there.
Yes.
Come while he waits for you, and accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. So you are no longer in bondage. You are no longer, hallelujah, under the law, because Christ came as the fulfillment of the law.
That's right.
He said in Matthew, don't think that I am come to destroy, hallelujah, the law, but I came to fulfill the law, Matthew 5, from verse 17 to 20. Don't believe I come to destroy the law. I came to fulfill the law. So if you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, the entire law is fulfilling him. So you have the whole entire law in your body. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Once you accept Jesus Christ, you accept the entire law. You live according to the entire law, because you have the one that the law is fulfilling.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus Christ, the same yesterday,
today,
and forever. And he's coming back for everyone. Hallelujah. That bow and accept him as Lord and Savior and live according to his words. There is no two ways about salvation. There's only one way. There's only one Savior. Hallelujah. It's Jesus Christ, my Lord. Hallelujah. So I charge you, everyone right around this world, that you take the name of Jesus with you. No matter where you go, what you're going through, you can call upon the name of Jesus Christ and obtain deliverance. Take the name of Jesus with you, child of sorrow and of woe. He will joy and comfort keep you. Take it wherever you go. When the trouble gets rough, the rough get going, take the name of Jesus. Call upon the name of Jesus. You will get deliverance. Call upon the name of Jesus. He will set you free because he will pull down the barns of guilt. He tore down the bars, the prison. He will set you free from all your misery, all your worries. There is naught to fear in the desert. If Jehovah is leading you, walk and talk and sleep with the Spirit. Hallelujah. Meditate upon the word of God every day, and your deliverance is right there at your side. Amen. Hallelujah. Be not disturbed, people of God.
Come on.
Be not disturbed. Be not confused. The word of God said, Be not conformed to this world. Don't take on the lifestyle of the world. Don't take on the behavior of the world.
Right.
But be thou renewing in your mind.
That's right. That's right. He can prove what is good.
Be thou renewing in your ways of thinking.
That's right.
Change your atmosphere. Change your thoughts. Hallelujah. Change the way you think about God, the way you think about Jesus Christ. Because not because one nation refused and rejected him, you don't have to reject him. You can accept him and inherit all that they, hallelujah, refused.
Thank you, Jesus.
All that they refused.
Yes.
Salvation was to be found in one nation, but because they reject, they object.
Rejected object.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so everything that they should receive, they rob themselves of it. Don't be like that nation that robbed themselves of their own blessing. Don't rob yourself and your congregation of your own blessing. See God in your entirety.
That's right. That's right.
Come thou fount of every blessing. Tune my heart to sing your praise. Streams of mercy ever ceasing. Call for song and loudest praise. Teach me, Lord God, some melodious song. To sing your song of praise, to worship you in the beauty of holiness,
yes.
To call upon the name of the Lord God when I'm in trouble. Don't, Lord God, forsake me. The Lord says, God, if you forsake him, I will laugh at your calamity when it comes upon you.
My God.
Seek the Lord. Hallelujah.
God.
Remember, those that were teaching were of another religion.
Right.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you this. You ever see a goat? You ever see a fowl stuck like a goat kid?
A what?
A fowl.
Okay.
A fowl can never suckle a goat kid because the goat kid needs milk and fowl don't have milk.
That's right.
So you of another religion cannot tell me, hallelujah, how to live as a Christian.
That's
because
right.
We are of two different species. You are fowl and I am goat. Hallelujah. You can't tell me how to live. Hallelujah.
Good one.
Because I need milk. To survive, I need milk.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I have to get into the word of God for my survival. You cannot, hallelujah, tell me how to live because you have not experienced the experience that I have experienced. So until you experience the experience I experienced, you cannot tell me about it. You have never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I have accepted the Lord as my Lord and Savior. And so I know how to live. I live according to the word of God. You don't have anything to offer me, but Jesus Christ gives me everything because he is the way. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He tells me how to live. He guides me in everything that I do. In the name of Jesus Christ, I ask, I beg of you, as Paul beg of us, hallelujah, to present our bodies as living sacrifice. Live according to the dictates of the word of God. Walk and talk with him each and every day.
Thank you, Lord.
We have to believe in a little while. But I leave this with you. If you are a cow, your calf needs milk.
That's right. That's right.
Give milk. Be at the place where you produce milk. Leaders of different organizations and churches, lead your people as Christ asked Peter to feed his lamb, feed his sheep. Hallelujah. Take care of those that is under your care.
That's right. That's right.
And for you to take care of me, you must first take care of yourself.
That's right. That's right.
So you must teach yourself. Hallelujah. So that you can teach others.
Right.
Teach yourself first. Follow the example that they give you on the plane when you travel.
Right.
Hallelujah. Protect yourself. Safeguard yourself first, and then you will be able to take care of others. Take the big plank out of your eyes, hallelujah, and then you will be able to take the sawdust out of mine. Hallelujah. Look to the Lord. Be constant. Be seasoned in prayer. Be constantly praying and asking for direction. Hallelujah. Ask the Lord to take care of you. Don't follow what other people are saying to you. Follow the Lord. Read the word of God. It is our basic example before we leave earth. Hallelujah. So everything, the Bible is the revealed word of God. It is the revealed word of God to guide us how to live. If he says that you must be holy, it's because he knows you can be holy.
Right.
Hallelujah. If he says that you must be righteous, it's because he knows that he gives the example in his word how for you to live righteous. Don't tell me that you cannot live according to the word of God. The Spirit of God lives in you to guide you and to keep you from all dangers and to teach you. He was a teacher.
Amen.
I will send, hallelujah, the comforter who will be able to teach you and to guide you into all truth. So he's the teacher. A lot of us not living according to the word of God because we're not reading the word of God.
That's right.
A lot of us refuse to live according to the Bible way because we don't read our Bible. We don't, hallelujah, do what the Lord says, that we must meditate, hallelujah, meditate in the word of God day and night. Let the word of God dwell in you richly.
Yes,
study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth.
That's right.
Yes.
You can't teach me the word if you don't know the word. You cannot tell me anything about God. You cannot tell me anything about salvation if you have never experienced salvation.
Yes.
You must know the Lord. Hallelujah. You must be living according to the word of God, living close to Jesus on Glory Avenue. Hallelujah. We walk and talk together as other neighbors do. If you are not having a solid relationship with the Lord. Yeah, hallelujah. You cannot teach others about the Lord because you're a part-timer.
That's right.
Hey, hello, somebody. You're a part-timer. And no part-timer can tell me about a full-time job.
Right.
Kneel down. Hallelujah. Search for him as hidden treasure. And accept him as your Lord and Savior. Remember, people, if you forget everything that you have ever learned and know about the Lord, don't forget this one thing.
Yes.
You need the word.
That's right.
You need the word to guide you in life. Even in your quiet time, you must read the word of God, which will drive you to prayer.
Yes. That's right.
Seek the Lord. Hallelujah. Meditate upon him day and night according to the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Don't let the word of God leave out of your mouth, but you must teach it unto your children. You must walk. You must talk about it when thou sittest in thine house, when thou walkest, when you go through your door, you must take the name of Jesus. Walk with the word. Let people see you talking to yourself and think you are a fanatic, but you are a fanatic for the Lord Jesus Christ, because you meditate upon his word and they see you grumbling and murmuring, but they don't know that you are actually praying. You're talking to the Lord. You're telling him things that you want, the changes you want to see in your own life, the changes you want to see in your children's life, the changes you want to see in your spouse's life. Talk to the Lord about everything. The changes you want to see in your community, the changes you want to see in your local church. Talk to the Lord about the changes that you want him to make in your life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. It is time to go.
Yes.
Circumstances alter cases. That's why donkey wear braces.
Huh?
Hallelujah. Everything that happens to you in life,
right,
you need to check why this is happening.
That's right. That's right, Apostle. Amen.
Maybe you're short somewhere.
Yep.
You're short in yourself because you can't short God.
That's right.
Look at Jonah. Everything that God tells Jonah to do, he says, I'm not doing it. Go down to Nineveh.
Yeah.
And tell those people that if they don't change their life, I am going to destroy them.
Yes.
Jonah said, I'm not going.
Right.
I am not going because you want these people to laugh at me. Because the people are going to hear the message and they are going to change their life and you're going to save them and I am going to look like a fool.
Right, right, right.
Jonah was a prophet of doom.
Mm.
He wants whatever mission you send him on, he wants to see the people suffer, because then he will rejoice. So could we say he have no mercy? But God is a God of mercy. Hallelujah. God is a God of justice. And if you repent of your sin, no matter what sins you may commit, if you repent of your sin, the God of justice will forgive all your sins and remove all your iniquities from before you.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
Jonah didn't want that. He wants to see the people suffer.
My God.
But we don't want to see no one to suffer. We don't even want our worst enemy to go to hell. Because if you know what hell is consisting of, you wouldn't want any human being to go to hell.
That's right.
But we thank God that there is hope. Thank God that if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive all our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness.
That's right.
So let us today, I close my Bible. Let us today remember Jesus Christ and the work that he came to do and the result of the work he did.
Amen.
Let us not forget. Let us not forget the work of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
He is able to change the heart of a robot.
Come on.
Hallelujah. No matter who you are. Hallelujah. No matter where you come from. Hallelujah. As long as you are a person, Jesus Christ can change your life.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
So let me borrow this line from Bob Marley. Hallelujah. And emancipate yourself from mental slavery. Because none but ourselves can free our minds.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
It takes me to change.
That's right.
It takes me to make the first step. It takes me to kneel down and bow my heart with my heart bowing lower than my knees and accept Jesus Christ as my Savior.
Amen. Amen.
Then my change will come. God bless you all today, right across, right around the world. Be sincere in your Christianity. And the Lord will change your life.
Amen.
I turn over back to the mother apostle.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The apostle to all nations.
Amen.
As she
teaches.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Can we say hallelujah? Hallelujah. Can we say thank hallelujah. You, Jesus? Amen. 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 To God be all the glory for the great things he has done. Thank God for Apostle Harakatabu Sotolie. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. We thank God for his grace. We're not going to keep going. Amen. The message has been preached. Amen. Glory to God. Recognizing the kingdom. Amen. Glory to God. To God be all the glory for the great things he has done. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Can we just begin to say hallelujah?
Hallelujah?
Can we just give God thanks for his word today? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, Alana, Isaiah, Micah, come on. Get back in, amen. Clap your hands. Let's worship the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go ahead and stand, please. Amen. Glory to God. Let's stand and honor the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God is moving by his spirit, by his power. Thank God for those of you who are streaming online around the world. Glory to God. God is shifting the moment. He's moving by his spirit. He's moving by his power. Glory to God. It's not by might or by power, but it's by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. Glory to God. We thank God for supernatural power. We thank God for Pentecostal power. We thank God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against us will prosper. Every mouth that rise up in judgment condemned. Why? Because we have the heritage of the servant of the Lord. We have accepted, believed, and confessed Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. At the name of Jesus, every knee will bow. Every tongue will confess that he is Lord. He is Lord of all. He is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Can we say hallelujah? Can we say hallelujah? Can we say hallelujah? Can we say thank you, Jesus? Hallelujah. Rabbi, come on, clap your hands. Clap your hands for Jesus. Hallelujah. We rejoice because he's made us glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice because he has made me glad. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Glory to God Almighty. Isaiah the prophet in Isaiah 6. In the year King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. The angels cried, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty.
Glory to God.
And Isaiah said, woe is me, I'm undone. Right now, in every nation, tribe, and tongue, woe is you. Hallelujah. If you do not repent and accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, right now, I want you to accept and believe. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. I accept that I'm a sinner in need of a Savior. Save me by your finished work upon the cross. Rescue me, Lord Jesus. I accept and believe and confess you as my Lord and Savior. Glory to God. The work is already finished from the foundation of the world. Jesus came into the world over 2,000 years ago. He demonstrated his finished work. Just like a baby is born into the world after 9 months. But God sent each and every one of us. We came from heaven. Glory to God. We came from heaven. And the only way back to heaven, glory to God, because you and I were created in the image and likeness of God. Glory to God. He said, heaven is my throne. The earth is my footstool. He said, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The world and they that dwell therein. For he has found them under the seas and established them in the blood. He said, who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord? Or who shall stand in his holy place? He may have clean hands and pure hearts. Or the lifting of your souls to vanity. Or swear deceitfully. He said, he shall receive the blessing of the Lord and righteousness from the God of our salvation. So the only way back to God the Father is through Jesus Christ the Son. You must have a perfect image, hallelujah, of who you are and whose you are. Glory to God, not by your might, not by your power, but by my spirit, says the Lord of hosts. What a great way, glory to God, hallelujah, to be able to minister from this upper room. For a kingdom takeover apostolic gathering on this eighth day. David was the eighth son of Jesse. He was the youngest son of Jesse, but he was the chosen one. And I pray and decree and declare today that you will become a part of the chosen. Glory to God, a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a peculiar people. You have seen, oh glory to God, that we have gathered here in the upper room, and my voice has been heard in the airways, and our voices have been heard in the airways through music, through testifying, that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of our testimony. Having a message in the oracle of God to decree and declare that Jesus Christ is Lord, that he gave the key of David. He said, the door that I opened, no man shut. The door I shut, no one opened. Glory to God. We thank God. Hallelujah for Jesus Christ. And he gave us the image, glory to God, to love him with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love our neighbor as ourselves. Come on, somebody. We thank God for his grace and we thank God for his mercy. Thank God for the message that was given today. Glory to God, the Apostle Junior Staple. Glory to God and the testimony of the Refuge and Restoration International Ministries. Glory to God of the Pastor Dacian giving it. Thank God for together they're able to leave this place, the upper room, as the apostles and elders. Hallelujah. Glory to God and the church gathered. Thank God for the affirmation. Thank God for Mommy Elaine Dana. Glory to God who came to sanction. Glory to God and see what God had ordained for her when she was 16 years old. God connected her with her husband. Glory to God, Pastor David Dana, who is now in heaven. Hallelujah, rejoicing that the generation of the seed of blessing did not pass by. Glory to God, and Pastor Sandra Dana, yes, give the Lord a hand, God, was able to carry the mantle of one generation to another. Will praise the Lord, and now all of the grandchildren can receive the blessing. Why? Because if you're out of alignment, God is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The Bible says Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob were heirs of the same promise. So we thank God for his grace and his mercy. Thank God for my children, Alana, Isaiah, and Micah Hinkson. Thank God for your elders and pillars here at God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries. Thank God for my husband and I. The two of us are one, and we stand together, and we allow God to do his will in our lives. Thank God for my father, Bishop Michael Williams. Thank God, glory to God, for Bishop Simpson. Thank God for Apostle Dyer Fisher and Apostle Carson Jackson. Thank God, glory to God. Hallelujah for Pastor Michael Williams. Thank God for Prophetess Ariel Stenloff. Glory to God. Amen. And those who grace us. Amen. Glory to God. Thank God for the blessing. Amen. Prophetess Estelle Helen. Glory to God. They grace us. Amen. During this kingdom takeover. And I know coming up in the next days and weeks, glory to God, we're going to be having those remainder of leaders that didn't get to come on during this kingdom takeover. We've enlightened them. We're going to have some to come on. But above and beyond, I'm looking forward for every nation. I'm going to be looking for representatives from every nation to be on this platform with me. And you're going to be connecting from your nation as you're connecting the dots, people to God. forming a network of God's kingdom builders. Amen. I want to go ahead and read, amen, Acts chapter 15. Glory to God, its entirety, as I'm about to close up this segment. I'm really excited. Please join us back later this evening. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'll be on. Glory to God. Looking to start. Glory to God. God's willing. Hopefully, we're able to start together around 7. Glory to God. And together and at least get into high gear. Amen. At a certain time, I just want to give a final word. Amen. To complete this kingdom takeover, apostolic gathering, rebuilding the tabernacle of David. Glory to God. So Acts chapter 15. Can you turn your Bibles with me there to Acts chapter 15? Glory to God. Thank God, Apostle Junior. I'm staying ready. I'm just focused on Acts 15 verse 1 today. Thank you, sir. It's a new beginning. It's a new beginning. Can someone say it's a new beginning? That's right. We have been encouraged last week that our bodies are the temple. We are the tabernacle being built. And now he began to tell us, even at a greater level, what it is, amen, to not be a man of another religion, but we should be of relationship with Jesus Christ. So Acts 15, it says, and certain men came down from Judea and taught the brethren, unless you are circumcised, according to the custom of Moses, you cannot be saved. Therefore, when Paul and Barnabas had no small dissension and dispute with them, they determined that Paul and Barnabas and certain others of them should go up to Jerusalem to the apostles and elders about this question. So being sent on their way by the church, come on, who are they sent by? The church. Who are you going by? The church. Glory to God. Who is the church? Those of us who have done our ABC. Accept, believe, confess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. And we understand the government, authority, and order of Jesus Christ from Genesis to Revelation, the canonical books of the Bible. We're able to allow our faith to be built up because faith comes by hearing and hearing by the word of Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So the word tells us, continuing, amen, glory to God, they went to the church, glory to God, hallelujah. So being sent on their way by the church, they passed through Phoenicia and Samaria, describing the conversion of the Gentiles. The word is conversion. Amen. When I go to Jamaica, glory to God, I take the U.S. dollars because, amen, and I convert it. Jesus told Peter, unless you are converted. Jesus, when Peter was flip-flopping, amen, back and forth, Jesus told Peter, amen, glory to God, when you are converted, strengthen the brethren. When Peter denied Jesus, amen, Jesus told him, Peter, the devil went out of you, sick this week, but I prayed for you ahead of time that when you are converted, you got to be converted. Come on, say, I must be converted. Come on, you can't be flip-flopping. You can't, if you're not converted, you're a counterfeit. And anytime you show up in an area, you're going to feel like a left out. You're going to feel like a bastard child. Why? Because you're a counterfeit. If you have not been converted to the image of the Son of God, God the Son, which is Jesus Christ, you are a fake and a counterfeit. Amen? Just up on this rock, he's going to build his church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against him. The Bible said that Paul withstood Peter to his face and rebuked him in Galatians 2 because he almost led Barnabas astray. Because when the Jews came, he was talking one way. When the Gentiles came, he was talking another way. And he almost brought confusion to the body of Christ. Don't think because a major leader is in place with hundreds and thousands of people mean that they are right. I've had to rebuke some men and women, glory to God of God, that I say are not on par. When I came here to Cleveland, Tennessee, listen, I was a part, amen, I didn't know about Church of God. I knew Church of the Living God. Until I came to Cleveland, Tennessee, I didn't know there was a denomination. And the word is denomination. I knew it was going down. And so I had to withstand some leaders to their face. I had to tell them, you're hypocrites. Amen. Glory to God. Why did I see that? Because, amen, even though the Church of God was in Jamaica and Florida and other places that I traveled, even the very ministry that my husband's father was over, the very home there in Barbados, amen, where he stayed as a bishop within the Church of God, guess what? He's run down. Because it's one thing to have your name on a building saying Church of God, you have these people, but if the people don't know the structure continually and you don't know put the right people over there, that's a problem. So God's willing, we're looking to get that home where my husband grew up, amen, under the leadership of his dad, amen. We get to get that home back so we can build it as an apostolic home. Amen. That when we go to Barbados, amen, glory to God, we can see that, amen, my husband's generation from his father as well, there's a prosperity level, his mother. Amen. That's what it's all about. One generation to another will praise the Lord. Amen. So when I came here, yes, I saw great levels of hypocrisy. I saw that, amen, when I came to understand that there is a Cocoa office and there is a Cleveland office, the blacks stay one place and the whites stay one place. That was division and dissension that divided the Church of God for so long. Amen. The Church of God, the Church of God of Prophecy, they had so much stuff going on in the court for so many years. Until they had to finally make some decision. There's no division in God. There's no Jew, Gentile, male or female. We are one in Christ. Amen. So thank God there's been sort of realignment and readjustment. Not because they intentionally did it. The children of God didn't intentionally cause deception. It's just that many people thought that if you're white or if you're this, you're up there. Now I want to give credence to those who are Caucasian. Yes, there's a different way that you roll. Amen. But amen. Also, the people, amen, whether it's Asian or African Americans or just African, if you want to call it that way, amen, there's a certain order. Like, for instance, I'm seeing lots of time here in Cleveland, Tennessee. Thank God for the sometimes too comfortable. You're calling a person by their first name rather than the office that they walk in. It's not about a title, it's an office. You can't call me a mother if I don't have any children, whether they are adopted or not. Amen. It's an office. It's a place that God puts you in. Amen. So, amen. Amen. When I came here, I didn't know that they weren't receiving women to minister. Right? And there are so many women that are within so many denominations. They are bound up. They are bound up. They are bound up and bind up right now. Not only in the Church of God, but around the world. There are so many women that are being persecuted. But the Bible says when Paul was persecuting the church, he was putting men and women in prison. Come on, somebody. So it's important for us to get into alignment. So the word says, verse 3 again in Acts 15. So being sent on their way by the church, they passed through Phoenicia and Samaria, describing the conversion of the Gentiles. And they caused great joy to all the brethren. And when they had came to Jerusalem, they were received by the church and the apostles and the elders. And they reported all things that God had done with them. But some of the sect of the Pharisees who believed rose up saying, it is necessary to circumcise them and to command them to keep the law of Moses. To command them. Not, come on, they were to command to do something that they're not willing to do. Now the apostles and elders came together to consider this matter. And when there had been much dispute, Peter rose up and said to them, men and brethren, you know that a good while ago God chose among us that by my mouth the Gentiles should hear the word of the gospel and believe. So God, who knows the heart, acknowledged them by giving them the Holy Spirit, just as he did to us, and made no distinction between us and them, purifying their hearts by faith. Now, therefore, why do you test God by putting a yoke on the neck of the disciples, which neither our fathers nor we were able to bear? Come on. Did you hear that? We. Neither the fathers nor we are able to bear. But we believe that through the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall be saved in the same manner as they. Can we say that together? But we believe that through the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, we shall be saved in the same manner as they. Amen. He said, then all the multitude kept silent and listened to Barnabas and Paul, declaring how many miracles and wonders God had worked through them among the Gentiles. Amen. And after they had become silent, James answered, saying, men and brethren, listen to me. Simon has declared how God at the first visited the Gentiles to take out, amen, to take out of them a people for his name. And with the words of the prophets agree, just as it is written, after this I will return and rebuild the tabernacle of David, which has fallen down. I will rebuild its ruins, and I will set it up so that the rest of mankind may seek the Lord, even all the Gentiles who are called by my name, says the Lord, who does all these things. Known to God from eternity are all his works. All his works. He knows what he's doing. He's all powerful. He's all knowing. Therefore, I judge that we should not trouble those from among the Gentiles who are turning to God, but that we write to them to abstain from things polluted by idols, from sexual immorality, from things strangled, and from blood. For Moses has had throughout many generations those who preach him in every city, being read in the synagogues every Sabbath. Then it pleased the apostles and elders with the whole church, said the whole church, the whole church, to send chosen men of their own company to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas, namely Judas, who was also named Barsabbas, and Silas, leading men among the brethren. They wrote this letter by them, the apostles, the elders, and the brethren, to the brethren who are of the Gentiles in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia, greetings. Since we have heard that some who went out from us have troubled you with words, unsettling your soul, saying, you must be circumcised and keep the law, to whom we gave no such commandment. They're clearing it up. We didn't endorse that. It seemed good to us, being assembled with one accord, to send chosen men to you with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, men who have risked their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We have therefore sent Judas and Silas, who will also report the same things by word of mouth. For it seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us. Can we say that it seemed good to the Holy Spirit? Can we say it seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us? Amen. Can we say, okay, can we please just give me a moment, please? Amen. It seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us. Can we just say that together? It seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us. Amen. Glory to God. We're all going to go together. Amen. Please, amen. I don't want to disturb and disrupt the Holy Spirit. Amen. It seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's important. Amen. That it seemed good to the Holy Spirit. If the Holy Spirit doesn't speak and say something, I don't do it. Come on, somebody. Amen. To lay upon you no greater burden than these necessary things. Amen. Amen. That you abstain from things offered to idols, from blood, from things strangled, and from sexual immorality. If you keep yourselves from these, you will do well. Farewell. So when they were sent off, they came to Antioch, and when they had gathered the multitude together, they delivered the letter. When they had read it, they rejoiced over its encouragement. Now Judas and Silas themselves, being prophets, also exhorted and strengthened the brethren with many words. And after they had stayed there for a time, they were sent back with greetings from the brethren to the apostles. However, it seemed good to Silas to remain there. Paul and Barnabas, amen, also remained in Antioch. Antioch was where the Christians were first called Christians. Amen. The believers are called Christians, teaching and preaching the word of the Lord with many others also. Many others. Then after some days, Paul said to Barnabas, let us go back and visit our brethren in every city where we are preached the word of the Lord, and see how they are doing. Now Barnabas was determined to take with them John, called Mark. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I just got it. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. I just got it. Called Mark. Amen. Glory to God. He says, but Paul insisted that they should not take with them the one who had departed from them in Pamphylia and had not gone with them in the work. Then the contention became so sharp that they parted from one another. And so Barnabas took Mark and sailed to Cyprus. But Paul chose Silas and departed, being commended by the brethren to the grace of God. And he went through Syria and Cilicia, strengthening the churches. What were they doing? Strengthening the churches. And it's important.
Good.
I just got it. I want to say what I just got. You know, I told Pastor Pastor Dr. Mark Williams of North Cleveland Church of God, the head leader and head pastor, I said, I want to lock in with you. And I just got it. When I said, and Mark, John called Mark. I know, I just got it. Amen. I told him recently, I said, Pastor, I realized that the message that the Lord gave me for the shifting was 2 Samuel chapter 7. And I heard Pastor Mark preach on that word. Amen. Glory to God. The last Sunday, glory to God, I believe it was in last year. And the Lord said, now shift with him and to go in because now he's ready to press in. Amen. And now I get it because that's where David had the temple. God told him, build the tabernacle, build the temple, and that Solomon, his son, his would become his successor. So I want to say to all of you, amen, around the world, glory to God, I want you to rebuild with me this evening. Please join with me this evening. Glory to God, we're going to come back. I'm going to finish up some word, glory to God, whereby we're able to lock in, amen, with the Lord. Glory to God, I'm getting ready, amen, glory to God, to make sure things are done correctly. Amen. Glory to God. As we're sending off these amazing leaders, glory to God, Apostle Staple and Pastor Dejan Staples are returning back to Florida today. Glory to God. Amen. These are just great leaders. And I thank God for all that they've received and learned together. And you'll be seeing them, I'm sure, a lot more. Glory to God, as we partner together and network together for God's glory. Thank God for Mom Dana that came today. Amen. Pastor Sandra, and amen. And I'm sure, amen, Mom is going to start coming a little bit more, right? Amen, right, Mom? Praise God. And give lots more of your testimony because God wants the testimony of you connected with Pastor David Dinner to be returned back to the earth. Amen. In this season, the Lord said to tell you the same way, glory to God, that I think Pastor was the one who told me about it, when they were trying to get rid of this building and they were going to shift it. And the Lord says, do whatever. Amen. Yes. The Lord wants you to share that message. Yes. So hopefully later, I don't know how much you're going to be up to it, but I want you to share because God, amen, God is restoring the tabernacle of David. You know, the other day I went through a major shift, and I'm going to tell you privately, so the Lord will tell you how to rearrange it. Amen. But it's regarding the caring place. I didn't know that your husband was instrumental in that. The other day, the Lord said, give something to the caring place. And it was when Pastor Sandra said, oh, my God. I was like, oh, my goodness. I was like, wow. So, amen. And I went through where they tried to come against me for a moment to try to see if they could remove somebody off the property here. So things was going a little off. So we have to return. So God is going to use you in this end time harvest moment, Mommy Lane Dana, to be able to put some things in motion. And God is going to help the entire family to help the church of God. I'm just here to help you guys help the church of God. I'm just saying. Amen. Glory to God. God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries is our headquarters by itself. We are reaching around the world. Glory to God. But I need to come and help different denominations. I've been traveling. I've been a part of the Methodists and Baptists, different people. What happened? Because we should be on one accord to honor the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. So now I get John Mark. John Mark was a protege to Peter. And John Mark had abandoned the work and didn't go on the missions trip that he was supposed to go on. And Paul said, I'm not going to take it. But Paul took Silas with him, who Silas was a prophet, who came down from Jerusalem. So sometimes we have to cross and move back and forth until things come back into alignment. But I now know that this is the time of the revival. That's the revival that's about to hit from Cleveland, Tennessee, Jerusalem, all Judea, Samaria, ends of the earth. It is here. It's now. It's happening. And I believe that by Resurrection Sunday, it's going to be a great move of God because everybody around the world is getting ready to see what God is doing. There's no Jew, Gentile, male or female, but we are one in the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to read this real briefly. 9 things you ought to know about the kingdom. Amen. I'm wrapping up. A kingdom is the sovereign rulership. This is by Dr. Miles Monroe, the late Dr. Miles Monroe, preparing kingdom, keep preparing for kingdom experience and expansion. Amen. This book. Amen. Glory to God. It says here on page 96, principles one, a kingdom is the sovereign rulership and governing influence of a king over his territory, impacting it with his will, his intent, and his purpose. Number two, in the fullness of time, Jesus came to the earth and reestablished the kingdom, because only a king can establish a kingdom. This act alone reveals Jesus Christ as the king. Number three, Jesus said that his kingdom was not of this world. He never said that he was not in this world. Amen. Number four, inside each of us is a latent kingdom consciousness striving for expression. Number five, we all seek power over things and over circumstances, and that is what the kingdom of heaven promises. Number six, a king is the central component of his kingdom. Number seven, a king is the ultimate and only source of authority in the kingdom, in his kingdom. Number eight, the sovereignty of a king is inherent in his royal authority. Number nine, God's sovereignty is absolute. He's completely self-determining. Amen. Let us stand for the blessing. Lord Jesus, I give you praise. I give you glory. I give you honor. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for blessing us. Thank you for strengthening us, oh God, from the inside out, Father, as we are about, dear God, to shift in a greater dimension, greater level. May you just, oh God, strengthen us, oh God. Forgive us of all sins and unrighteousness, sins of omission, sins of commission, sins of ignorance and arrogance, oh God, and pride, and all the deeds of the flesh. And may we produce the fruit of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, temperance, and faith. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We give you all praise and glory in Jesus' wonderful name. Can we say in Jesus' name? And not to him was able to keep us from falling and present us faultless to his great throne. To the only wise God be glory, majesty, dominion, and power, both now and forevermore. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord keep his holy counsel upon you and grant you his shalom in Jesus' name. Peace, peace of the Prince of Peace. Amen. I want to play this song. Amen. By Micah Stampley. Amen. Heaven. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Want to play that? Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hang tight, Mom. Not yet, Mommy. Just a moment. Amen. Yes, please. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We bless the Lord. Amen. Just a moment. We're going to play the song. Amen. Alana, if you could get the screen going for me, please. Amen. As we are finishing up. Amen. Glory to God. We thank God for his grace. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. We thank God that we're looking for the grace of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Just to the highlights. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you all for being a part of the Kingdom Takeover Apostolic Gathering from the Upper Room. Holy Spirit experience, and you're going to be having some time with me throughout this week so we can unpack all that God has said. Amen. Glory to God to us. Amen. Glory to God. To God be all the glory. Amen. Let's highlight the entire ministry globe with the nations, with the continents on it, please. Glory to God. Thank God for all of you from North America to South America to Africa to Asia to Europe to Australia. Amen. Oceania, Antarctica. Amen. The ends of the earth. We thank God that the earth belongs to the Lord, and we now return it back to him in Jesus' name. Amen. Yours truly, Apostle Dr. King, Son, and Mother, Apostles of the Nations. I want to say thank you so much, Lord and God, for the blessing. May the Lord bless you. I love you all. The peace of God reign with you, and I'll see you later in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye.